What a welcome for the number one team in the country. As you hear the boos in the background at Steve Spurrier Field in Ben Hill Griffin Stadium. First trip for the number one team into the Swamp in 19 years. Since 1992, when Florida and Alabama met in the conference's first championship game, much of the story of modern-day SEC football has been authored by these two teams.
Alabama wins the inaugural Southeastern Conference Championship.
Florida, winner of seven SEC championship game titles, the most recent coming against Alabama, coached by Nick Saban. In the rematch the following year, the tide was turned, kickstarting a dynasty largely responsible for the program's nine SEC championship game victories.
Alabama, the dreaming is over.
Last season, the stars aligned once more, and these two teams met in the championship game for the ages.
Touchdown, Alabama!
Touchdown, Gators!
Alabama survives in a great SEC championship.
The dawn of a new season's brought new faces to familiar places.
Yes, it looks long. Touchdown, Alabama! Richardson, he throws the ball. Touchdown, Gators! Oh, man!
And now the Tide and Gators are ready to write yet another chapter in their storied rivalry. And this chapter is chapter 42. Alabama has won the last seven over Florida, their first trip into the Swamp for the Tide in 10 years. And with that, the Home Depot, SEC on CBS brings us to Ben Hill Griffin Stadium, the Swamp in Gainesville. It's top-ranked Alabama. It's number 11, Florida. A packed house, over 90,000. It's the hottest ticket in this facility in a long, long time. Welcome, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler with Gary Danielson and Jamie Erdahl. Partner, what a way to kick off a full-fledged weekend of SEC action, and we get a rematch of the beauty we had at Mercedes-Benz Stadium back in December, the title game between these two.
Ness, I was thinking, we've done a lot of games together in college football. Is there anything better than a highly ranked team going on the road to battle a legitimate team? Is that the best you can do?
It is, and the best that we've seen over the last 4 years. You know, you didn't even have to have last names for the Alabama quarterbacks.
Right.
It was Jalen, Tua, Mac. Now it's Bryce.
It is, and this is one cool customer, Bryce Young. He's taken over a program. He knew what he was stepping into. The success here, what's expected of the quarterback, but he has been groomed for this job. Now, it's going to look a little different. The crowd is one thing. Last year, Mac Jones got to do it with nobody in the stands and a Heisman Trophy guy. This time, there's a plethora of receivers. No names yet, but running backs and receivers. A little bit more by committee, but we know this. Nick recruits good players.
Well, Bryce Young is the man. For Florida, it's the men, because they got two quarterbacks that have played very well in the first 2 weeks.
It's worked so far, these two guys. But out at practice, the first thing, the storyline has been Richardson hamstring. And it's right up until game time, still a question mark.
Well, speaking of the question mark, maybe we can get an answer from Jamie Erdahl. Jamie.
Well, our ears certainly perked up yesterday when Anthony Richardson told us that his first and worst hamstring strain came back in spring football. So what we saw from Richardson last week was actually a re-injury of that right hamstring. Saturday evening, he had an MRI. Friday morning, another one. The imaging says the hamstring has greatly improved. He is medically cleared to play. However, when I spoke with head coach Dan Mullen an hour ago, he told me that Richardson will not play today unless Emory Jones gets hurt. Guys, a far cry from the two-quarterback system Mullen really wants, but Richardson has cleared himself medically to do backflips during warm-up, apparently.
Okay, so if that's a bad hamstring, partner, how can he play when he's healthy?
If I could do that, I'd still be playing.
That's right.
Well, it's going to be a lot different. Florida's gotten comfortable with the two quarterbacks, making the defense look at both guys. So it's Emory Jones' job, but you can see what Dan has done with two quarterbacks. He's done it in the past with Chris Leak and Tim Tebow. So now, Emory Jones, who I thought kind of felt the athletic ability of Anthony Richardson behind him, has to calm down. It looks like his game. He's up against the best. Let's see what happens.
I know one thing, the crowd's not calm. Number 11, Florida. Number 1, Alabama. The kickoff is coming up in moments. The Home Depot. Alabama's on the road against number 11, Florida. They expect one of the 10 biggest crowds the stadium has ever had for this one. As guys are still rolling in, Dan Mullen in his fourth year took the Gators to the SEC East title and then lost a close one to Nick Saban's Alabama club in December. Pre-game, Dan Mullen, a hug to Megan, a can and his son, and Breland, his daughter, a kiss for luck, and we're on our way, I guess, as the song used to say. Nick Saban, all business. Well, Miss Terry's maybe on the trip, I don't know, but in his 15th year, with 7 national crowns, 6 of those at Alabama, and his stay in Tuscaloosa. They first met in 1916, these two teams. Alabama leads the all-time series, and they've won 7 straight, as I mentioned earlier. First meeting in 10 years here in Gainesville. You know, I was thinking about it, Garen. I thought, well, how can it be that it's been 19 years since number one team was in here to play Florida? And then I thought, oh, Alabama hasn't been here in 10 years, so that takes care of half of it.
Well, and here's another little note. The last 2 games I've done here with Alabama and Florida, one in 2006, Mike Shula's still the coach of that team.
Oh,
Urban Meyer wins that game, goes on to win the national championship. 2011, against his Florida team, Nick Saban comes in and wins, and they go on to win the national championship.
Let's see if these two can end up in December where they ended up December of 2020. Florida won the toss and deferred, Alabama to receive. Jace Chrisman to kick. Here we go. And fair catch taken, and that'll bring it out to the 25 for the Crimson Tide offense. Here's the man we talked about, Bryce Young, off to a red-hot start, threw 4 touchdowns in their opener against Miami, which was the best opening performance by a quarterback in Alabama history. Making his first true road start, and he's hearing about it already.
Not in style of play, Ness, but his demeanor reminds me of Jalen Hurts.
Yep.
Just calm. That's the word. He just, when everybody else might be a little nervous, he is dead calm.
Already thunderous noise on the first snap of the game. And it's Brian Robinson on a cutback. And a good run for Robinson. A pickup of 5. Here are the players that we'll see today. Presented by Papa John's on the offensive side. For the Crimson Tide of Alabama. No more Devontae Smith and Jalen Waddle. But you still got John Metchie and company on 2nd and 5. And the throw is out to Slade Bolden. Bolden across the 40, big gainer out to the 45-yard line. So just like that, Alabama, great field position.
Well, that's the RPO game. You've got an end man on the line of scrimmage that the quarterback reads, and you can always go out to the quick screen. Blocked well outside. Bolton gets it, and he's into the secondary for first down before he's even close to being touched.
Pick up of 15. From the 45, that's Metchie in motion. Young going to go deep. All the way down to interference coming. It was Jamison Williams, the intended receiver. And Trey Dean is the man that ran him over.
Well, Jamison Williams is the fastest receiver on this Alabama team this year, number 1.
That's interference.
And as you see the interference, actually it's a good penalty because it probably would have been caught, a 15-yard penalty. Bryce Young waited a little too long on the play. Had he thrown that ball maybe a half a second earlier, it would have been led into the deep, you know, for a touchdown. That has been really the only thing that has yet to emerge for Alabama. Bryce is 1 for 10 on throws of more than 20 yards.
Well, they pick up 15 on the penalty, and they're in Florida territory at the 45. Jaleel Billingsley is in motion. Quick screen out, Williamson. And he got about 7. Williams picks up 7 as we take a look. at the Florida Gators. Some of the defensive guys, Zachary Carter, Todd Grantham says, we got to find out if they can block him. He's already got 3 sacks on the season. He's one of their leaders on the defensive front for Florida.
So new offensive coordinator Bill O'Brien is doing a lot with Steve Sarkisian did. You nullify the pass rush with these short, quick passes early and give a lot of confidence to the quarterback.
Second down and 4 at the 34. Opening drive for the Tide. Young had that tipped, I think, and it's incomplete. Not sure if somebody got a hand on it. It looked kind of weird coming out of there. It was intended for Jameson Williams again. So here's the first third down of Bryce Young's young road career.
And was it Cox who tipped it or inside? Yes, it was Brandon Cox, number one.
Third and 4. Alabama 50% so far in the early season on their third downs.
Billingsley in the game. I guess he's out of the doghouse,
yeah,
right?
He's been in most of this series now. Yeah. He's part of that trick package to the top of your screen. And the crowd might have gotten to the all-SEC left tackle.
I'm not, was it delay a game before that? Did he get it in time? Interesting, which, is it going to go against Florida? Clock was going down. Interesting call here.
Yeah, Bryce Young was clapping and clapping and clapping. And
the
snap
back
wasn't
judge
coming.
Threw this flag. He's the one who's looking at the play clock. Now they got to talk it out to see who had the flag first.
And the play clock there in the corner. Yeah, they didn't get
yeah,
it off.
Yeah, I don't think so.
And it was almost simultaneous yes. on the flinch. Yeah, quick call. Okay. Nick Saban wants an offside on the right defensive end for Florida.
So the back judge overruled the offside.
But this is a break because they get another snap here. I mean, it's a longer yardage situation on third down. But it would have been really long if it would have been the left tackle.
Either way, they would have got another snap.
But it would have been deeper than this. Third down and 9. Heavy pressure, first down, and Jameson Williams had been the main target, Gary.
Well, Chris Bogle, number 8, has a free run at the quarterback on the play. Watch right there. Free run, and right where he goes, he's replaced. Now, you make that tackle. That's what you got to do. Tackling in the space has always been a big story when you're playing against modern-day football. You give him the short pass, you've got to make the tackle.
Trey Dean really leveled Young as he got rid of the ball, but he got the first down at the 28. Brian Robinson, big hole off the right side. Knocked down at the 5. Had a little misstep. I wonder if he got hurt as well. That was a kind of a funny landing after the attempted
well,
tackle.
And Robinson comes up gimping just a little bit. Right side of that offensive line that time. Echior and Owens do a good job of turning him out. Watch him both turn his guys out. Sprint 15 yards downfield before he kind of gets rolled yep. up that time.
First and goal after 23-yard pickup by Robinson. Jace McClellan in there now with Robinson on the sideline. Young high snap bobbled, picks it up and dives forward. He's going to lose a yard or two. And just to make sure, Antonio Valentino was there to cover him.
Snap was good enough.
Yeah.
Yep.
Maybe he took his eye off a little bit.
Just dropped it over his right shoulder. Got to be able to make that play.
This is the opening drive for Alabama. They're just joining us. They've worked it down to a second and goal just outside the Gators 6. 8th play of the drive. McClellan will motion out of the backfield. Young's going to look that way. Got it to him. Put a move on one man. And did he get there? He did. Touchdown, Alabama.
So one delay a game, one drop snap, but everything else, just like Alabama has always done it.
Pretty good, huh?
Yep.
Our AT&T 5G pylon cam. Here's another look as he's going to come right at you. Chase McClellan with the dive and well into the end zone with the touchdown. His second receiving touchdown of the year. Rodgers' extra point is up and good. As Gary said, methodical 75-yard march in eight plays. A little over 3.5 minutes. And Bryce Young's got his eighth touchdown pass of the year. Some of the new faces in familiar places. The end zone, 7-0. 4-7 Sports News Network. Download the CBS Sports app to watch today. You can even watch my partner, Gary, join the HQ team.
It's me. I'm going to have a tough person to follow up as we look at a couple guys you don't want to follow up. I'll tell you that right now.
Commissioner Greg Sankey and Heisman Trophy winner here in his days, Tim Tebow. So when you open up with a touchdown on the opening drive, you usually get beat by Alabama.
Yeah. And if you don't, on an opening drive, you usually get beat by Alabama. They usually win. But, you know, the play, you get maybe one shot at stopping them. And they had them third and long.
Right.
You make that tackle on a short pass. Good call by Todd Brantham, the blitz, and they don't come up with the tackle.
Rackard's kickoff. Fielded at the 2 by Jamarcus Weston. He's not going to get the 20. Maybe the 17 got buried by the Alabama special teams. And so a little bit of a hole for Florida's offense to start in. And to start is number 5, Emory Jones, native of LaGrange, Georgia. He's waited his turn behind Felipe Franks, Kyle Trask. So far this season, the interceptions is the one thing that's been a little bit of a problem.
Right. There's been a lot of good, but then the plays that are bad are too bad.
Yeah.
You know? So, you know, everybody here, everybody on all the message boards, you know, the backup quarterback's the guy. Emory's got to have a good first drive.
Off the play fake and the throw. Completion for about 2 yards to Kamari Gamble, the tight end. Here are the players we'll see today, presented by Papa John's. Offensively with Emory Jones. Copeland's been his main target as Jacob had career highs last week in their win over South Florida. Jones to throw over the middle again. Nice catch and maybe a first down. Very close, and it's Gamble again. Well, they've been looking for a tight end since Kyle Pitts went to Atlanta in the draft, and they haven't used one much.
No, not in the first two games, but against this Alabama defense, they love the matchup inside. The number 3 receiver or the tight end on the linebacker, that's where they want to get it to.
He got a first down at the 27. Whittemore in motion. Ground game for the first down, at least from the running back. And it's a good one. Nice run by Malik Davis. And the defensive players will see today for Alabama. They'll rotate a lot of guys in, especially that front 7. And this guy's been an unbelievable transfer portal guy. Henry To'o, who we watched for 2 years at Tennessee, be the leading tackler. He's now the middle linebacker and making the calls for the Tide on that side of the ball. 2nd and 6, a little hesitation, and the pitch to Davis got the corner. Still going, and Malik Davis is out across midfield.
Coming into this game, I believe that if you didn't establish the threat of a quarterback run, they weren't going to move the ball. They did it with the option right there. In essence, the quarterback tackled Drew Sanders, number 20, by pitching the ball. He threw the tackle, pitched it, and that evens the numbers in the offense.
Pick up of 20 to the 49 and a first down. Emory Jones stands tall, flips it out, got it too far ahead of Malik Davis, the intended receiver. Anthony Richardson looking on as Emory Jones is running the show here on this opening drive. There he is with the headset on. Seems like every snap he's had has been a big play, and that's why the fans around here keep calling for him.
He's showed some athletic ability that's off the charts. We saw with the flip, but in the game, just as much. Well, did he do it soon enough this time? Did Garage do it soon enough in the reaction to get the penalty? Alabama moved into the neutral zone, and Garage reacted.
Offside. Defense.
Yes, right. Yes, he did.
Tim Smith is a guy that jumps.
Yeah, right on the tackle right at watch. Wait. Oh, boy, that was delayed. I was wondering if he'd get away with that. But he did.
The big left tackle gets the call. And DJ Dale comes in as Tim Smith gets the penalty and gets brought out of there.
By the way, Will Anderson in the game, number 31. End up in his spot.
He was a question with a knee. But he's in there, and he's an all-SEC, all-American type player. Jones throws complete. Gamble, again, has been huge on this drive. It's his third catch. And he almost broke that one open.
A little bit of a delay from the tight end this time. Motion to change the numbers, but watch Gamble just slowly and then come out. Hits and then comes out. The motion changes the numbering for the Alabama defense. I got number one, I got number two, starting from the outside in. And then just a little bit of delay. Beautiful call by the Florida offense.
Here's a run all the way for Jones. Broke one tackle, broke a second, down to the 17-yard line.
So Henry Toa, number 10, had it read. But this is what the running quarterback can do, especially a big guy. Pulling around, run through one tackle, spin through another, and makes a positive play. This is the offense. Listen, Kyle Trask was great at what he did last year.
Right.
But there's no Kadarius Toney, Kyle Pitts out there. This is the kind of offense Dan is more used to running.
And we just had Alabama Tuatolo, I think, jump in the neutral zone again. At least that's what the Florida players are saying. And if so, it'll be a first down by penalty. Sneaking up there a little too
I'm
much
sorry.
Here.
Defense in the corner. Jumping into the neutral zone and causing the reaction by the offensive player. 5 yards penalty to go for the first down.
One thing I noticed out of practice, unlike other teams, Florida multiple times goes on the second clap from the quarterback. Alabama goes on the first clap, so maybe in practice they've been used to moving on that first clap.
Good call. Damian Pierce.
There it is.
Split out as a wide receiver. They're going to try the same play as Jones weaves his way inside the five. Got it to the four.
One thing this Florida offensive line does well is pull. They don't take a lot of guys on straight on, but they block down and pull around. Very effective.
Florida can get a first down without scoring.
Not here, but whoa.
Well, Damian Pierce cuts it outside, but he's going to go down for a loss back to the eight.
That penetration from that Alabama defensive line there just blew this play up before it got started.
Christian Harris is the guy that made the tackle, but as Gary said, that front wall that stopped his forward progress allowed number eight to get out there to make the hit. And this changes things considerably. It's third down and six. They can get a first down at about the two.
Remember, Florida had their chance, didn't do it. Now it's turned the tables. Five across the board.
Jones scans the field to the end zone, and it's broken up at the goal line, intended for Justin Shorter. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, Amar Davis that time did a good job because Justin Shorter is a big receiver.
He's about 6'5".
Plenty of protection, plenty of time. And good job by Amar Davis that time.
Florida right now still got their offense on the field.
Ball could have been a little lower. That's the only critique. But good defense there by number five.
Yep. Apparently, they're going to go for it. Fourth down and six. And now whistle.
I'm not so sure about that.
Well, maybe Dan Mullen's not either.
Yeah, I'm not so sure.
We can straighten it out during
the Yes, exactly. Right?
7-11 remaining first quarter. On CBS, Alabama's defense hoping to survive this opening drive by Florida that's taken them all the way down the field. But on fourth down and six.
I would take the points here early in this football game. You know, they didn't get a stop. And I think in the back of Dan's head, that first drive by Alabama and the last score, 52-46.
Yeah.
But I think the decision correctly is the field goal.
Chris Howard will come in and try a 25-yard field goal.
Successful drive, get your 3 points, depend on your defense. Don't show lack of confidence in them so early in the game.
Chris 2 for 2 on the year so far. From the right hash. to try to get the Gators on the board. From 25, kick is up and good. So an impressive opening march by the Gators. Didn't net them what they'd hoped for, which was a touchdown. But they'll take the capper on a 75-yard march. As Gary said, get the points, 7-3. Tomorrow on CBS.
So Todd Grantham, the defensive coordinator for the Gators, he goes, all right, there's no 22 out there. He rushed for 187. Devontae Smith, number 6, caught 15. Their quarterback got drafted high. All three number ones. It doesn't look any easier over there.
It doesn't, does it? Freshman to kick. And taking the lead is Jameson Williams. Out to the 25 comes the Alabama offense with a 4-point lead. Unique shots of today's game are provided by the Home Depot. What a gorgeous place. What better place to be, right, than the swamp? Although maybe by halftime, it might be a little swampy. Good chance of rain. Hot and muggy, and a great start in the first 8 minutes of this game. Alabama scored on their opening drive. Florida countered with a field goal. So 7-3. Jace McClellan in the backfield with Bryce Young. Young to throw to Bolden, complete, pick up of about 6.
So Brad has mentioned defensive tackle Zachary Carter earlier in this game, number 6 for Florida, playing that defensive tackle spot. He's up to 285 pounds this year, playing close to the quarterback. I think he's a real key guy in this football game, but the short passes have neutralized him so far.
Second down and 4. McClellan is wrapped up in the backfield in a loss of about 3.
Jerron Moon, holy cow.
The moon rises.
So he's in for Ventrell Miller, number 51, who's injured and probably out for the season. But number 7 times it. It's not blocked well. And you could see the mistake. Cohen, number 70, should have come off and rubbed off, and he didn't get it.
Jeremiah Moon, a 6-year guy, and he said, I've seen that stuff before.
Third down chance for this defense again for Florida.
See if they can get off the field. Alabama needs to get to the 35. Crowd is deafening right now. Bryce Young has a look to the sideline and a backup look to the clock. It's down to 2. Well, it looked like some motion, but I guess they got the snap away and the throw's incomplete. And now there's a flag at the very end of the play. Kyir Elam.
Yep. Menchie said he was held. The official agreed with him. Was not a blitz, but it was bump and run coverage, man to man.
Pass interference, defense number 5. The penalty breaks the ball, it's front of the foul, and it's an automatic first down.
Here's the matchup.
Ooh.
Well, I don't like
that
call.
I don't know about
that.
Not at all. Offensive pass interference.
In fact,
maybe.
Mechie grabbed his jersey. I think that's a tough call, and that's tough to play bump and run coverage. If it's going to be called that tight, it's going to be tough on both sides, and that's the style both sides like to play.
Throw over the middle is behind Mechie. And if that would have been on target, he might still be running.
See, that's the slant pass that Tua was a master.
Yeah, he was.
Okay, and last year, Mac Jones came in and took it from there. Not better than Tua. Best slant passer I've ever seen. But you're right. If this thing's on target, Mechie does a good job, it's going to be grab onto his ankles because that's your only chance to save a touchdown.
Second down and 10. Mechie in motion up on top of your screen, and now we've got a timeout, I think, taken by Florida. With 5:46 remaining.
They might have had 12 guys on the field for Florida. Guard Penny, look at Alabama right here. This is how you do it. There's 5. There's 5. Ness, take over.
There's 2 more guys back there.
You got it.
You were testing my math
skills. Got it. Yeah, you got it.
So it's second down and 10 still at the 39. all the receivers to Bryce Young and Chase McClellan's left side. As Zach Carter would love to get some heat on the Alabama quarterback. Now Mechie comes back in motion. Young throws out of desperation. McClellan made a guy miss. I'm not sure how, but a heck of a run after it as well. So the man that scored the Alabama touchdown looked like he was going to get dropped at the line of scrimmage or maybe a loss, and he made a big play out of it.
Second big play. This is an easier tackle than the last time. Bernie had him. Number two for Florida. Come on. Make this play. Great. Duck. And goes forward. Almost comes down on his knee, but that's a positive play. But not for Florida. Got to make that tackle.
That play fake didn't work, but it ended up in a wide open McClellan again down the near sideline this time. But Jace McClellan has been the man so far, number 21.
So the yardage, the extra yardage that was gained on the play before allowed new offensive coordinator Bill O'Brien to get a little fancy here. A little play action pass. Bryce knew right away that I had him. A linebacker sniffing inside. It was short enough yardage that he had to stay there. And then the end of the play.
So McClellan's been huge. He came in because Brian Robinson went out earlier and looked like he was shaken up, but he's back out there. So he's okay. And so is the Alabama offense. Throw out in the flat, complete to Mechie. Got the edge. And Mechie got about eight before he's run out of bounds by Torrance.
I'll say, so first glance here, we're in the first quarter of this game. It just appears that the Alabama athletes are just better than Florida. No matter what angle the Florida DBs takes, it seems to be the wrong angle. Mechie looked like he had two guys there right around the corner pretty easily.
Well, they've worked it down to the 26 already. Second down and two. It's JoJo Earl, freshman receiver, who's in the lineup. They think he's going to be something special, maybe kind of like Daylon Waddle. He's going to waddle over to the left. Fakes that he was going to take a handoff. The throw is to wide open Billingsley. If he got the pylon, he got the touchdown, and he did.
Okay, two shifts, one motion, and the Florida team got confused. Billingsley went out and up, and an easy throw, a beautifully designed play. He's right here, then the motion, and then Alabama gets in the backfield. He runs actually into Mechie on the play. That's what changed it. Mechie runs into his man, and he tiptoes to the pylon.
Wow. 75 yards in seven plays. Speaking of pylon, from pylon cam, here he comes, and there he goes into the end zone. It's 14-13 right now, soon to be 14. Will Reichard set for the point after.
Nicely designed play that time, and Dan Mullen knows he's got his work cut out for him.
Extra point is up, and it is good. 75-yard march in seven plays. Jahleel Billingsley was in the doghouse of Nick Saban a week ago. He's in the penthouse right now. Capped off by a 26-yard touchdown pass, pass and catch. Bryce Young to Jahleel Billingsley.
Florida had their chance to get out of that one again. That pass interference call, that was a rough call.
That was a rough call, I think, yeah.
Yes.
That was rough in a lot of ways.
and also, being on the Florida bench, the official calling that one, I know they don't want to listen, but usually they hear, you know, but that was, could have gone either way. Maybe I should rephrase that. It's hard to believe it was called on Florida.
I'm with you. Rocket kick. Fair catch called for. And that'll bring Florida out to the 25-yard line with their second offensive series. Last time they took it down 75 yards in 11 plays, but they were stymied when they got it down close to goal to go and had to settle for the Chris Howard field goal. Jones still at the controls. Looked good in that first drive, both throwing and running. Naquan Wright is with him in the backfield.
Probably the best receiver of the running backs in the game.
He's got some quicks, too. A but it's Jones keeping and slipping, and his knee goes down, a loss on the play. Will Anderson was right there spying him.
Yeah, he was matched up against the tight end that Zippier that time, number 9, and Anderson handles him. Comes in, he's got to get him for the block, but he blocks him really right into where Jones was attempting to run the ball. Took on the block perfectly that time, number 31 did.
Behind the chains for one of the few times today. Second down and 13. Try to run it off the right side. Got back to the line of the original line of scrimmage.
Interesting conversation I had with Pete Golding about how he's going to try to fuse the Florida offense. He said, I want to disguise the defense to Dan Mullen, not the quarterback.
Flag down.
Crisis snap. Timeout. Alabama. They're first.
Alabama takes a timeout.
Did they have 12 guys on the field that time?
These defensive coordinators just want an extra guy, don't they?
Yep. They go dime defense, nickel defense, then, no matter what. Too much money in your pocket right here. Yep.
Yep. International. All those elite teams proving that justice has no borders. Starts Tuesday on CBS. One night, a lot of FBI. Emory Jones is going to be calling for the FBI, and he threw it right to the defender for Alabama, Jalen Armour-Davis.
Well,
and
Jalen
the first
Armour,
turnover of the game.
That's Jalen Armour-Davis gets the interception, but give it to number 20, Drew Sanders, with the pass rush. He gets in there and forces a high throw on the play.
So this is a problem we talked about earlier. Emory Jones is going to be his fifth interception. He's thrown through two games and one quarter.
Needs some help on this one, though. Right in his face as he lets go, he gets it. And that's just too quick. Ball could have been thrown, I guess. But when you get hit like that, as you're letting the ball go, the receiver went inside, the ball went outside. Turnover.
There's the hit.
Yep, and I think that caused that ball to go a little bit to the outside on the play.
You don't really want to give Alabama a short field, but they got one here. The 38-yard line after the interception. Pistol set with Robinson behind Bryce Young. He gets the quick handoff off the left side. Brian Robinson still running. First down, Alabama, as he picks up 11 before Trey Dean finally drags him down.
One of the things is Alabama offense, even though they probably would love the quarterback to throw every time, they love to keep it balanced. Follows number 55, Ekior, just clear it out, run behind the pulling guard.
Back all over the place, false start.
Number 55, 5 yard penalty, still first down.
So that'll back him up five. Quarterback comparison so far, there isn't much of a comparison as Bryce Young's been almost perfect. That last drive they had, that was 15 plays, they had four runs and 11 passes for Alabama. There's Anthony Richardson on the sideline. Again, may or may not play. First down at 15 now for the Tide. Back at the 32. Crowd trying to help their defense. Young, plenty of time. Deep ball on the sideline. Incomplete. That was intended for Williams. I hear Elam, nice coverage that time.
Absolutely. Cut off the fast receiver. Put your body on him. Make him slow down. And
a little hand fight going.
Yeah, that Elam said, that's about what I did before.
Yeah, really.
Maybe a little more. Perfect coverage.
Cameron Latou is in at tight end, set up on the right side on a second and 15. Offensive lineman trying to hear the call, kind of lean into each other. Empty set for Bryce Young. Looks to his left and goes that way. He's got a man wide open. It's Mechie. Mechie with a stiff arm out of bounds around the 20. So it's going to bring up third down and short.
Type of player John Metchie is. Now, remember a few years back, Alabama's loaded with four, we all knew, number one draft choice wide receivers. And all of a sudden, we're hearing about number eight. This guy deserves some playing time. I'm like, wait, against these guys? And he goes, yes. He's good enough to take reps against those four.
Judy and Ruggs and Waddle and Smith.
Yep.
They just keep churning them out. Third down and five. As they marked him out at the 22. Blitz coming. They pick it up. Young goes short over the middle on the run as Williams dragged down first and goal. On the crossing route, he just got ahead of everybody.
So if you can pick up the blitz, you can make people pay for it because there's a lot more space. Watch Ekior 55. That's what makes the play. Moon comes in, takes him right down, smashes him. Plenty of room for Bryce Young to step out. Perfect execution by that offensive line. And then the Ohio State transfer turns the corner.
Oh. At the 7, first and goal. Play fake it to Robinson. They go to the end zone and skips off the hands of Bolden, incomplete.
That was a fight back there, wasn't it?
It was.
Perfectly thrown by Bryce Young. High enough, only his guy could get it. When you make this throw, you see the defender's helmet facing the other way and go, see it?
Yep.
No way that Johnson, number 16, could make the play. And he goes, I'm just going to give it. It's almost like a back shoulder throw in the middle of the field.
If Slay Bolden's an inch taller, he maybe makes that catch. One of the shorter receivers for Alabama. Second down and goal. All three wideouts to the top of the screen, including Bolden, who's in the slot. Final minute, first quarter. Bryce Young rotates the ball in his hands, gets it out to Brian Robinson. A move and a touchdown, Alabama. So that's touchdown pass number 3.
So the power running back made a corner, Elam, number 5, miss on that play. Again, it's not just two guys. This offense has about 8 guys that can make plays at a high level. Dump it out, make number 5 miss, good athlete, and Robinson takes it into the end zone.
Brian Robinson, who waited his turn behind Najee Harris and those guys, and he's in the end zone for the second time this year. Reichert in for the point after. It's 21-3, and we're not through the first quarter. Only a 38-yard drive after the interception. Second running back to score a touchdown off the arm of Bryce Young. Three, top-ranked Alabama on the road. Just capped a short drive with another touchdown pass for Bryce Young. This thing's been a clinic so far, Gear.
It really has, and, you know, you talk about comfortable. Again, number 9 exudes it, and, you know, when you go watch Alabama practice, the competition every day in practice, they go, you know, all right, there's not 90,000 people there, but it's tough every day. That's part of the key to why this team plays so well on the road around the world.
Rackard's kick, and Florida calls for the fair catch. He'll bring it out to the 25. Now it's time for our hometown connection presented by T-Mobile. Here's Jamie.
Well, John Metchie has certainly solidified himself as one of the top wideouts here at Alabama, but he is truly a man of the globe. His hometown is up in Canada, but his mother is from Taiwan, and that's where he was born. He moved around because of his mother's family and her work, but he settled in Canada before going to boarding school in Maryland and New Jersey. But you know the old saying, home is where the heart is, that's where his mother is. He hasn't seen her in over 2 years because of the COVID-19 pandemic, but he hopes she'll make it to a home game this season.
Wow.
And there were a lot of good scores and plays, but maybe the play of the game might have been Metchie's hit on that interception. Remember that?
Yep.
He forced that fumble.
Henry Jones running for his life right now, throws and completes it to the tight end. That's a 4th catch for Gamble. And Gamble got it out just inside the 30.
So you got to figure if there was any chance that Richardson was going to play in this game, he'd be in there for this series, right? So it seems like the die is cast here. It's going to be every Jones game, unless he gets hurt.
Just 36 passing yards compared to over 100 more for Alabama. Second down at 5. He'll keep it. Emory Jones does this well as well. And across the 40. That should bring the first quarter to a close. E.J. Dale ran him down, but a good run for Emory.
Again, if Emory's going to struggle throwing the ball downfield, you have to kind of do it the way Dan did it at Mississippi State. Run the quarterback. Nick Fitzgerald is going, I had to do it.
All Alabama in quarter number one, the Tide on the road with three touchdowns and a 21-3 lead. Set to start the second quarter at the Swamp in Gainesville. Alabama on the road controlling things through the first 15 minutes with a 21-3 lead. Florida from the 41-yard line on the opening snap of the quarter. Keep it on the ground. And bring up a third down. Brad Nessler, Gary Daniels, and Jamie Erd all down on the field. Well, Dan Mullen had about 3 or 4 minutes to talk to his team. What's he tell them during that timeout?
I think, you know, how the coaches keep these playbooks on. All right, okay, I'd go right to the part where it says quarterback runs right here. And I would just say, Emory, you got to establish the quarterback in the running game, and then the play-action pass game will come after it.
There's the play-action pass, back shoulder, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, because going to the drop-back game would be right here.
Right.
Like, I'm not
that's
doing
that. That's kind of empty.
That's why I said the drop-back. I would use that as a last resort because it's not Emory's game. He's got to get in there, run the ball, run the option, the zone read, try to make this Alabama defense a little bit uncomfortable with the running quarterback, and then try to open up the passing game.
See if they can just keep this drive going. They're not going to get all the points back in one fell swoop. Third down and four. Nice throw. And a first down at the 44 to Trent Whittemore.
Third and manageable. That's where it has to go. Making those third down conversions. This Florida team has to keep it third and five, third and four, third and three, and that allows the easier throw for the quarterback.
He put that one right on the money. So the Gators do keep the drive going at the Alabama 44. That's Whittemore in motion. Alabama comes with a corner blitz and a little shovel pass on the inside.
There you go. Well, nicely defended that time.
Will Anderson made the stop.
Yeah. Will Anderson is just not as elite, have a lot of ability, number 31, left side of the line. But he goes from the quarterback and plays the shuttle pass inside. And he plays with a high motor every play. Watch 31.
He's an All-American, without a doubt. Here comes a blitz again. Jones has time, running out of it, and trying to run out of it. Got back across the line of scrimmage, picked up a couple. Phil Mathis, and again, it was Anderson who made some havoc.
If you said keep your eye on number 31, this time a wonderful stunt inside. He got all the way inside on Reese, the guard, and that flush. Emory Jones out of the pocket, he got what he got on the play. Started out wide, stunt designed that time. He got inside to make the pressure.
Anderson had a couple of sacks and a forced fumble in that SEC championship game back in December. Gets a little breather here on this third down and seven. And it's quarterback draw all the way. Jones isn't going to get there. It's fourth and two.
Let's see if Dan goes hurry up here. Remember, hurry up last time caused Alabama into a timeout. You got to believe the way the scoreboard's looking. You got to think four downs.
This is kind of a dead spot on the field as far as your field goal kicker. Almost 3 yards to go now, the way they spotted it.
The no huddle kept Alabama's defense from substituting. Now you got to pick out the play and make it work.
Here we go. Fourth down at three. Clock winding down. They might not get this off.
Oh, man. I had to take a timeout. So the thing is, if you're going to punt, you can just take a delay of game. It doesn't make any difference. But with 21-3, it looks like Dan wants the fourth and three, right?
Yeah, I guess so. It is a timeout. Their last one comes with 12 minutes and change remaining in the first half. We'll see what they do when we come back. Dan Mullen with his quarterback on the sideline, having taken their final timeout of the half with 12 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the quarter, and it's fourth down and three. And with the gravity of the situation, I guess, being this far down and being in a weird spot on the field, they're going to go for it.
Well, Gamble, number two, the tight end, has caught four already. He's been their best matchup. Is that where he goes?
Mullins called the play, and Henry Jones apply it for a first down. Gonna have to hurry. Ball's tipped in the air. Incomplete. Alabama takes over. Somebody on that interior got a hand in it. And so the fourth down goes awry. Nick Saban happy with his defense.
Coming off the edge, right off there, right into him. Really, no really place to go. Defended not only with a good pass rush, unblocked off the edge, but really nobody to throw to.
Brian Branch is a guy that deflected it. He's played every position in preseason in that secondary, and in this case, comes on the blitz and got his hand on it, and it turns it over to the Alabama offense at the 37. They've had three drives, three touchdowns, three touchdown passes for number nine. Billingsley has one of those. He was in motion and just set up in the slot. Young thinking about going deep. They've got his jersey, and he throws it in the dirt, so they finally got a little bit of pressure on him.
Not sure about that one. He might get intentional grounding on that one.
Dexter is the guy that had his jersey.
Nowhere to go with the ball. Dexter comes in, grabs him, and yeah, he threw it. Almost on the ground.
The penalty places the ball at the front of the foul and includes the loss of down. Second down.
You had that call a lot quicker than the officials did.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's just about a 3 yard spike.
He didn't even get past the line of scrimmage. So a lot of green on there. And then the touchdowns in black. That's not bad. Nice combination, right?
No doubt. Very Christmassy.
Christmas in Florida.
Uh-huh. Second and 16. Crowd again, trying to come up with a defense to make a play. Young fires, incomplete, intended for Earl, and broken up at the last second by Johnson. There's Johnson.
Johnson on the slot. That's a tough one to get it. Good speed. JoJo comes back for it, and well defended. That's how you got to battle those throws.
That's good, a bang position. Bang play. Yep. That's a good throw and an even better defensive.
Absolutely.
Play.
Good precision by the offense and better defense.
Finally, Alabama to third and long here. Their average third downs, just a handful. This is three handfuls plus. Just a three-man rush unless they blitz. They won't. Young still getting flushed out of the pocket, throws on the run and broken up again. This time intended for Mechie. And Elam got a hand on it. And finally, Alabama's got a punt.
So the penalty and the mistake early was not able to be overcome, and then the Florida defense steps up. Three-man rush, but just enough because of the long yardage that time. And again, you're up 21-3. Bryce Young doesn't want to make a mistake here. Looks deep, keeping it back in. That means he's got not much, and then dumps it up. Two good defended plays by Florida. Maybe the defense can give the offense some juice.
Maybe. First punt by either team as James Burnett set to kick it. Xavier Henderson is back deep. And he might take this on the bounce. No, he's going to get out of the way. And he takes an Alabama roll down around the 21-yard line.
Just remember, if you're Florida, you were down by 18 at halftime in the SEC Championship. You got to go. Keep fighting. Get it closer.
Took it right out of my mouth. I was going to say we're going to be in Dallas next week for that one, and that will be an indicator maybe on who's in the West a threat to Alabama, if there is such a thing. A lot of football to go. We'll know more in about 3 weeks, right?
I think so, but as usual, as in the last, 12 years, you better bring all of your A game to beat Alabama.
So Florida got their first stop. They take over at the 21-yard line. Damian Pierce in the backfield with Emory Jones. Receivers punched in tight is the play fake. Plenty of time, and again runs out of the time. He got a nice gain out of it, though. Picked up about six as we test your knowledge with today's Aflac trivia question.
Aflac.
Who's the last SEC East head coach to defeat Alabama? It's been a long time. Can we go? It's 31 straight games, if that helps you. We've got a Gator player down.
Well, I'm going to, can I give a hint? Was it on the injury? I know who the injury is to. It's Delance, the right tackle. The hint on the Aflac?
Sure.
I did the game.
Okay.
So I can remember.
Well, that's not fair.
Well, people can eliminate some games, you know, if they're avid CBS SEC people.
Right.
Under 56 on the right side of the screen.
Ended up in a pile. It's kind of hard to see what happened.
He was pounding the turf, so you know he was upset with the injury. He felt that it was a bad injury.
We'll be checking on him when we come back. 11:23 till halftime. There's Gene DeLance limping over towards the tent, the senior out of Mesquite, Texas. Only wearing a heavy brace on his right knee, and
so
that looks like it's the problem.
That's a concise, tight formation for Florida. They try to go deep on the play, but is defended. Look at the safeties right there. Nowhere to throw the ball. Emory has to come out of it and get what he can for 5 or 6 yards.
DeLance, when he goes out with an injury, got probably the best block on that guy all day long,
right.
And then he ends up getting injured on the play.
Second and four, Gators.
Michael Tarquin will take his spot at that tackle position. Second down and four. Inside handoff. And that's only going to get about a yard for Damian Pierce.
Damian Pierce, the ball carrier.
Alabama over the years, common denominator, to look at that yellow streak down the right-hand side. Don't throw any interceptions, and you might get lucky and beat these guys.
Yeah, you've got to play well, and you have to take care of the ball. That's what it, you know, early, what was it, 2015, Ole Miss beat Alabama early. Alabama turned it over five times. They don't do that very often.
Right. 6 of 11. And that one interception. Here's the option.
Uh-oh.
Late pitch.
Yep.
And To'o says no.
Yes. The double clutch allowed number 10 to say no on that play. You're exactly right. Strung out very well. Watch number 10. Strings out the option. And then forces the pitch. And was a little bit of a horse collar there at the end of it.
You got jersey. I think that's what Pierce was calling for.
Oh, I don't know. I think that's horse collar right there.
He got him right in the Pierce.
But I think that counts. Got away with one.
So they're going to have to kick now because of the field position, 4th and 2.
Florida 1 for 5 on third down.
Cross shot, a punt. Slade Bolden is return man. Whoa, hit this a mile in the air. Bolden says, I don't even want to field that. I don't have to. It bounces at the 30-yard line out of bounds. That's where Alabama takes over with 9:41 remaining in the half. They're controlling the game here at the Swamp.
New.
All right, Zook, see you at halftime. And right now, time to do Project Smarter, presented by the Home Depot. Do smart things like spread the ball around to all your kind of new faces, I guess. Chase McClellan, who had a reception, a touchdown, and a block punt last week for touchdown, scored. Then Jaleel Billingsley hadn't played much because he was in Coach Saban's doghouse, and then Mechie and company. So two touchdowns to the backs, one's to Billingsley, which is a wide receiver slash tight end. And that's doing things smart for Bryce Young, mixing it up to a lot of different people.
So Alabama's only run for 34 yards. I wonder if they're going to try to dial up the run game a little bit right here.
They'll try this one. It's McClellan, broke one tackle, puts his head down, and goes for 5. Yeah, he had a big game last week. He had 4 rushes, including a touchdown. Caught a pass for 21 yards and a score, which he did similar today. And then he had a 33-yard block punt return. His first guy, an Alabama player, has scored 3 different ways in a long time. So he starts emerging. You still got Trey Sanders that we haven't seen. Brian Robinson's the proven vet who's waited his turn. They're still pretty loaded where they need to be. Second and five. Play action. That was way behind Williams, the intended receiver. I don't know. It was a mix-up between quarterback and receiver.
That was an RPO, and the quarterback makes the choice there. And, you know, right now, you got to wonder, like Coach says, all right, these RPOs are good, but we could run a couple of these plays. If we're going to throw the slant like that, we're going to take the P part of it out of it.
Right. Take the R part. That was the first really errant throw by number nine all day so far. Now he's got third and five from the 35. Play clock just got it off. Young steps up in the pocket. Throws on a run deep and broken up, intended for Mechie. Elam's back there, and so was Trey Dean, and Elam's the guy that's still down.
This is exactly what Bryce Young has been doing in the two games on tape. He gets out of the pocket, but he keeps his eyes downfield. He does not like to scramble and run. He looks for the big play when he's flushed out, lets it go, and Elam does a great job at the last second of getting that hand and distracting Mechie enough. Mechie could have caught that football, obviously.
And Elam, the guy that ended up on the bottom of the pile after making the play, and he is their best cover man. Preseason first team All-SEC. Hopefully he can just walk things off, but it's not looking great. Four straight incompletions for Young, which is oddity, and it forces another punt.
Since we put up the Christmas tree.
All the red and green?
Yes.
So the second Alabama punt from James Burnett. Xavier Henderson back deep.
Nobody on the slot. Who comes out here late? Now he's going to go in.
Old crosses over to set up to help block. Aussie style punt fielded right about at the 21-yard line, where Alabama's got it back offensively. Let's check in with Jamie.
Well, we wanted to review as to why Florida fans are probably asking. They're not seeing Anthony Richardson up until this point. Again, he re-injured a right hamstring last week. The original injury happened in spring football. He has kept the headset on in terms of helping Emory Jones throughout this game. He's been on the on and off the bike. But, guys, in terms of body language, he truly does not look as if he is getting ready to enter this game. He's had no conversations with head coach Dan Mullen as if trying to convince him that he should be in. And, of course, to remind you, Dan Mullen told me before this game that he would only use Anthony Richardson in an emergency situation today if Emory Jones got hurt.
And he said his MRI yesterday morning was about a 50% reduction in the amount of strain on that hamstring. I said, did you pull that when you grabbed your leg when you hit the end zone on that play? He said, no, I pulled it at the 50-yard line.
A little bit earlier.
Good run by Naquan Wright.
So those kind of dissecting calls that Coach Mullen was able to use last year when he had Kadarius Toney and Pitts. He was able to isolate those guys and get some big plays. He's not been able to find that. You could call it quarterback play. You could call it better defense from Alabama. But he's not been able to steal any chunk plays in this game so far.
Jones looking for a throwback. Had to throw late, but he got it complete. On the runner with a blocker in front is Zimmerer. And he's in Alabama territory at the 45. Elam's finally brought him down, so there's a chunk play. It looked like it was going to be a blown-up play.
Yeah, and he's coming right across the formation right here. And I don't exactly – oh, did he run into somebody on the play? Going so shallow that Zippier's wide open for one of the few big plays for this Florida team.
30-yard pickup to the 45.
Touchdown here will make this a lot different crowd.
Longest play today for the Gators. Play fake. Jones double clutches and throws incomplete, intended for Whittemore. Josh Job was back there covering.
Here it is on first down. If it's not there, you know, you're not a drop back pro passer. Maybe you'll grow into it. But on first down, You got to take the easy throw right there. Just take that one right in front of you. Get the 5 or 6 yards. You know that crossing guy's coming right into your face. Look, pretty good coverage. If he's not wide open, come to your backside guy for the easy first down play.
7.5 minute mark. Saquon Wright splits out to the top as an extra receiver. So 5 in the pattern. Jones zips it on too far behind.
That's the easy one. That's the crowd's going to notice. There's been a lot of passing in this stadium. I don't know if you know that.
Yeah, there has.
And they
there's
can
some
tell.
Statues outside.
So this is the one that says, all right, this is one you got to make. We can set them all up for you. We know Alabama's got a good pass rush, but we can't miss on a throw like that.
As long the wingspan as Shorter has, wasn't long enough. And Jones carries to the 41, and the Bluebirds are out again on fourth down. They came in near record crowd to watch this matchup against the number one team, and it's not going their way so far.
So they have had two straight stops here. Are they just looking to draw them off sides, or are they going to hand Alabama the ball in the 40 if they don't make it?
Fourth down and 6. Blitz coming. They're going for it. Jones going to go deep, and might be an interference back there, or is the ball caught anyway? The flags fly. Copeland saying, I didn't get a chance to catch it. I think he's right. Josh Job, the guilty party.
It's funny. Jordan Battle, number 9,
that's
is going.
Defense, number 28. It's going to 15 yards.
Oh, yeah, he got his hand up there. You got to call that. They had a small one earlier that was called against Florida. You got to call it. What they're saying is the official standing right on the sideline didn't throw the flag. And the judge, middle judge, back judge, threw it. And Jordan Battle's going, man, you were right there. Why didn't, you know, you said it was not interference. And the flag comes from another official. But I think it's the right call.
And a first down at the 26. So there's a little bit of life by penalty in the Gator offense here. Jones and Malik Davis in the backfield. And it is Malik straight up the middle. Davis heading to the end zone, and he's in. Touchdown, Florida. Now the crowd's alive.
Right up the middle, the blocking right there. Center and left guard pushes it right out of the way. Good job. And Malik Davis rolls over and falls over and gets it into the end zone. And you say, one score, the crowd goes from booing to we got a ball game, they think.
That's all touchdown because his body was on the defender as he rolled in. Chris Howard for the point after.
Oh,
and he missed it.
Yes, he did.
Well, only bad part of that drive. But remember, first it was the long ball from Emory Jones, intended for Copeland. There was a pass interference on Joe that kept the drive alive. Malik Davis, number 20, goes 26 for the touchdown, 21-9. Missed extra point gives us a 21-9 count. Coming up, Adam Rick and BJ will have first half analysis and highlights from around the country on the Geico Halftime Report. 6.5 minutes from now. This one's going to be returned from the 5. Anderson Williams. Williams got it out about where they would anyway at the 25-yard line. A little bit earlier, we tested your knowledge with our trivia question, which was, who's the last SEC East coach to defeat Alabama? You got to go back a long ways, but it was the old ball coach, Steve Spurrier.
Yes, it was.
2010.
Nobody would have guessed that. Alshon Jeffrey, Marcus Lattimore,
yeah.
Steven Garcia.
Steve Spurrier, Florida Field.
Slowed the game down and just made the play.
Coach Spurrier hosted us Thursday night at his new restaurant.
Great place.
Yeah, sure is. Brian Robinson back at tailback behind Bryce Young will get the carry. And he'll get only about two. Nice job defensively by Daquan Newkirk. He's one of those transfer guys as well. Came in from Auburn. And Antonio Valentino, whose number we called a little bit earlier, came from Penn State. So that beefed up the inside a little bit from the transfer portal for Todd Grant.
Remember in the SEC championship game, Alabama rushed for 187 yards. About 177 of them were from Najee Harris.
Young steps up. He's in trouble and got whacked by Brenton Cox.
So Brenton Cox gets the sack. But this, the clock, the mental clock in Bryson Young's head right here has to go a little quicker. Nobody open. Good coverage. Good coverage. And when he goes to leave, Cox is standing and then getting him from the blind side.
Backed up to the 24. Another third and long situation. Right on full force right now for Bryce Young. Three-man rush. He goes short over the middle on a crossing route to Metchie. Metchie's going to get swarmed under at the 30, and Alabama's going to have to kick again.
That's three stops in a row for the Florida defense. Remember, Florida gets the ball to start the second half. Big part of this football game right here.
So Berner comes out to punt again. And Xavier Henderson waits back there at the 30 on the other end. See if he can return this one. Henderson going to field it, but he gets buried immediately. And it's Williams down there on the special teams. Starters play on special teams.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. The gunner, sometimes you'll see Metchie on it in the past. You'll see Williams, he's the fastest player on the team. McClellan is right there cleaning up the tackle, but that time the wide receiver makes the play.
Well, that'll look good in the film room. Special teams.
It's the first pressurized drive for this Alabama defense, probably all season.
Yeah. Right here. They've been good, but a couple of mistakes on that last drive, especially the fourth down pass interference.
Just
kept
remember,
the Florida drive alive.
Florida has no timeouts, but still plenty of time to run the ball.
This won't be a run unless it's a quarterback.
Oh, yeah.
It is. And he got about four. Christian Harris inside to make the stop. Clock will wind its way under 4 minutes before the next snap. Dan Mullen hoping for more points here in the next 4 minutes. Second down and six. Empty backfield. Emory Jones wants to throw. Crossing pattern. Got it complete. Rick Wells into Alabama territory.
So the game plan again is get it to that slot receiver. Third guy in from the outside. That's the matchup they want. It's on a linebacker. It's on Toa Toa. You get a wide receiver on a linebacker, and that's where they pick it up. Ooh, almost fumbled that ball. But the defense counts from the sideline in to count the receivers. One is the widest guy, two in the middle, and three in the slot. This time, four receivers for Florida to the bottom of the screen.
And it's Damian Pierce the other way, the running back. Jones running out of time, looking for a crease, doesn't find it. He's dropped for a loss. Tim Smith in on the play along with Fedarian Mathis. That 26-yard pickup got him into Alabama territory, but the sack has him back right at the midfield stripe. Second down at 12. 2:40 to go in the quarter, and as Gary said, no timeouts for the Gators. Had them all used up with 12 minutes plus remaining in the half. Here is Pierce trying to head to the left corner. Pretty good run.
Absolutely. Nice job by that Florida, that Gator offensive line that time.
Flag on
the play. Was it nice because they held left side of the line? Good job by Garage. It's, oh, a tug in the secondary that time. You could see it right at the end. Was it Wells? Number 12? Yes, it was.
Third down.
That's the guy that had the big pass play. Now he's got the penalty.
It was at the end unnecessary. He's blocking, then he grabs right at the end.
Armour Davis was the guy held
there
right
there. There it is right there, yep. He holds, and then everybody does the same thing. It's like when they're kids. They take a cookie and they put their hands up like this.
I did not do it. Those are not my grubby little fingers on that cookie.
Right.
Backed up to the 43. That's not the direction they wanted to go after the big pass.
And here's where you have to be careful with an inexperienced quarterback. Can't make a big mistake here.
Blitz on Toto. He's in a loft of speed, and it's going the wrong way again. Drew Sanders drew a bead, and it's third down and a whole bunch now.
We're seeing a lot of Drew Sanders, and we will see Dallas Turner as well, number 15 later. But Drew is playing because Chris Allen, the starter at that position, has lost for the season. Drew, an emerging second-year player, and getting better and better.
This is one of the emerging guys. We're talking about emerging offensive players. You said, Gary, Chris Allen out with that broken foot for the year. So he's one of the guys helping pick up that slack. Wells in motion, third down and 23. And they're just going to play it safe.
Yep.
Naquan Wright's dropped.
Can't make a mistake here, but still plenty of time for Alabama to take maybe a timeout here.
Will Anderson again on the play. Man.
Will Alabama take a timeout?
How many number 31s is there on the Alabama side?
One is enough.
He is good.
No, they're not going to.
JoJo Earl's going to drop back, waiting on this punt. Crawshaw.
I would think since they're not taking a timeout here, if I was Florida, I would get rid of this punt quickly because they'll go for the block.
Crawshaw does a nice job of getting rid of it, and it's a beauty. JoJo Earl way back at the 9 with a fair catch, 9 or 10. Good punt. With 35 seconds remaining in the half. Football action continues tonight on CBS Sports Network. Utah battles San Diego State at 7 Eastern. And that's followed by 14th ranked Iowa State on the road to take on UNLV. That's a doubleheader coming up tonight on CBS Sports Network. 53-yard punts as Alabama back just inside their 10-yard line. You don't think they would do much with this.
I would think if you're a Gator fan, you go, okay, not exactly what I had hoped for.
Yeah.
But if you're Dan Mullen, you go, okay, we've got three stops in a row on defense, something maybe I could get in the locker room and build on.
Bryce Young is in the shotgun. He's going to hand it off to Brian Robinson, who's going to lose a yard. That should just about do things for the half. Boy, the first quarter, it looked like Alabama was going to run away and hide. They had a big lead, and it seemed like every drive was better than the previous one. But as Gary said, the Florida defense has come up, stiffened up.
It started with that intentional grounding. They got behind the chains.
Yeah.
And then that Florida defense kind of got the feel of it, and three straight stops for no points for Alabama.
But Bryce Young looks a little bit
the same.
He looked like he wanted more than 21, but he does have three touchdown passes in the first half. Florida will get the ball to open up the third quarter. So the number one Tide heading into the locker room with a 21-9 lead.
Can't get too close.
Let's check in with Jamie.
Coach, has Emory Jones continue to show you enough to not use Anthony Richardson in the second half?
Yeah, well, you know, with Anthony with his injury, I mean, we got to be really cautious with him. I thought Emory's playing pretty good, you know, in the first half, making some good decisions, getting us into the right plays, managing the game, made some good throws. We just got to execute cleaner, you know. I mean, we got to get more time. There's some opportunities that guys are open and we're getting hit. We got to be a little bit more efficient offensively. We made some early mistakes defensively, you know, giving up some first downs and penalties where we settled down.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
That's in. Into the first half, 21-9. Top-ranked Alabama with the lead as we send you to Adam Zucker and the guys on New York Studios. The Geico Halftime Report. Zucker.
All right.
Back to start the third quarter. Home Depot SEC at CBS from Gainesville, Florida and the Swamp. Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, Jamie Erdahl, we welcome you back. Just about set to start the third, partner of first three drives for Alabama. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Right. Last four drives, if you can include that one play to end the half, 10 total yards. So there's something for Florida to hang their hat on.
I think so. But also, I think at the beginning of the game, I don't think, you know, the first two games that Florida played didn't get them ready at the start of the game. The different angles, better athletes, you know, Florida Atlantic, South Florida, not Alabama. Once I think they got feel of the game, they were taking better angles on defense. I think the story for me of the first half so far has been Alabama doesn't have any balance and has not been able to run the football.
Only 30 yards on the ground. And Florida will get the ball first. That's good news for Florida fans who've been a little bit impatient at times today. Some wondering why they haven't seen the second quarterback, Anthony Richardson. We've documented that as thoroughly as we can, the hamstring problem. He would be an emergency quarterback and probably wouldn't play the same way that he normally does. And Emory Jones set to take the field as we check in with Jamie.
Well, not enough balance for Alabama. Nick Saban would also say not enough intensity and commitment, especially when he wants a full 60-minute effort out of this team. When I asked him if he felt like the intensity dropped off in the second quarter, he said, yeah. Did you? I mean, Coach, why did I ask you? Of course, that's what we observed. But it's a little intense when Nick Saban asks you the question back.
I like it. You had to ask it, and we didn't.
I had the answer. So this is the first time you've ever asked it back.
First down at the 25 for Florida, opening series of the third. Play action, Jones fires, and a seam route incomplete. Any pass interference? Yes, there it comes.
Yep.
Jacob Copeland, the intended receiver. Josh Jobe, guilty again.
That was the full Monty there. All three flags were thrown on this one on Jobe. Ran right up the back.
Pass interference, defense, number 28. The penalty is 15 yards and includes an automatic first down.
It's not what Coach Saban was hoping for to open the third quarter.
Now, you don't know when you're covering if it's a perfectly thrown ball. I don't know if that was catchable or not. Probably not.
So first down at the 40. Malik Davis in the backfield with Jones. Alabama shifting on their defensive front. And it's Emory Jones. And he's got close to 10.
Yeah, that was a designed quarterback run all the way that time. Fake inside. You see number 20 crash down and just follow the tight end right behind. Positive play.
Gamble with a nice block. Pick up of 9. Second down and a yard. You see the rushing yardage disparity between the two teams. And second and short. He's going to throw a sidearm and he slings it beautifully to Copeland.
That may be Emory Jones' best play of the football game. He gets out of trouble using his legs. Then he stays calm, looks downfield, gets the receiver who's going against the grain, and throws perfectly on the run.
First down at the 41. So into Alabama territory on the opening drive of the third quarter for Jones. Back on the ground. Malik Davis for 9 more. They're battering the Alabama defense right now a little bit with a ground game.
As soon as you establish that quarterback run, you kind of go back to that experience that Dan had at Mississippi State when he had Nick Fitzgerald and he ran the ball. I think he had more than 20 carries in that football game. There it is.
Jones on the keeper. That's a first down. A look at the trends in the first half. Bryce Young, 10 touchdown passes, 3 starts. Ties an Alabama record to Mac Jones from last year. Emory Jones, what he did in the first half and first three drives, as I mentioned, all touchdowns. The last three were punts and then just one more play to wind the clock down to end the second quarter. That was definitely an ebb and flow And right now, the flow's with the Florida offense.
Right, so that Nick Saban defense and Pete Gold, they have to figure out how to stop number five right here.
First down at the 30. Jones, pitch, Davis. And even though it wasn't much, it was about a three-yard gain again.
Yes, we all know that Dan Mullen's 0-10 against Nick Saban, but he came close at Mississippi State. He controlled the ball. He controlled third down. He ran the ball with Nick Fitzgerald, and then at the end,
of course,
there was a guy.
Devontae Smith was out there somewhere.
Calvin Ridley had an important catch right before that, but it was a very close. Tied it right until the end, until that last touchdown pass.
Second down at 7. Whittemore in motion to a slot. And settles in as Jones didn't see a blitz coming. Pitch was perfect to Davis. Head of steam, Malik Davis. Down to the 12. To'o To'o made the stop. But he gashes off the left side.
Yeah, well-designed play here. Coming, and Richard Garage, number 76, does a great job of getting around the corner and blocking the linebacker. Gets in To'o To'o's face. That allows the play to get downfield. To'o To'o makes a tackle, but downfield.
That's what you call opening the garage door.
There it is.
At the 12, first down. Great-looking drive from Florida to open the third if they can make it pay off for a touchdown. That pass is high to Davis, but he brought it down, and he got it to the 6.
That's the stress that the modern formations of putting your running backs, your tight ends, all over the field, and then you throw easy passes to them. Good blocking up front. Good job that time by Shorter, one of those big wide receivers, to clean the way for Davis.
They actually spotted him at the 7, so it's second down and 5. They can get a first down at the 2. Damian Pierce in, as Davis had done most of the work in the backfield. And now it's him blocking for Emory Jones, who's got a yard, and that's all. Third down and 5. Marco Helms made the tackle.
So as you get closer to the goal line on these quarterback runs, the safeties get closer to the quarterback as well. He's the one that made the tackle. Very hard to account for the safety in your blocking scheme.
Here's the biggest third down of the day for Florida. Jones, the pitch. Pierce trying to get to the edge. Got to make a couple guys miss. Yep. Almost got there.
Here's the thing. Is it close enough to go for it?
Looks like it's a yard or maybe a little bit more.
Did those last couple evasions by Pierce on the option again? He evades one. Cuts back on 2 and gets a little bit of positive yardage. Is it close enough to go for it? I would say yes. Wouldn't you go for it?
Hey, playing number one team.
Absolutely.
In of course, I'm not making the decisions that guy's making.
And,
but
and
here
you're
we
not
go.
Making $7 million a year.
Well, how do you know? Fourth down and 1. First down, maybe a touchdown.
Beautiful.
He's in. Touchdown, Pierce.
Ran the ball left. Ethan White. Equicon, the center, does a good job, number 65. And then Pierce just falls forward. Great effort. Offensive line does their job. And oh, he stretches out his knee. I don't think his knee was down. I think this one's going to count.
You can see him being mobbed by his teammates on the sideline. You also might have seen some of the players patting Coach Mullen on the backside as if to say, Coach, thanks for having the guts and the faith in us to go for this thing.
Well, I think the execution by number 5 was good enough to trust him, too, on the option and on the pass plays.
Extra point this time is up and good. There's much more than just life in the swamp. 75-yard drive, 10 plays. Damian Pierce stretching out for the end zone to cap a 4-minute, 40-second drive. Hang on, folks. 21-16. Swamp is starting to rock a little bit now. 21-16. Our unique shots of today's game provided by the Home Depot. 90,000 fans alive now after just what the Gator ordered. An opening drive of almost 5 minutes, covered 75 yards and a touchdown. And now we got a ball game. And Alabama will bring it out to the 25. Coming up Monday, our favorite neighbors are back. Brand new season, but get ready for some shade because the family tree just got interesting. Find out how these neighbors are related on the season premiere of The Neighborhood, Monday at 8, 7 Central, right here on CBS. Cedric the Entertainer and Max Greenfield and company. Cedric's doing the Emmys tomorrow night. I think he did a home video show on CBS last night. Dude's busy.
Keeping busy.
He's busy. Well, it's getting busy in here, too.
It is, and now a pressurized drive for Bryce Young. You know, in the third game a year ago, Mac Jones was at Ole Miss. And that was a high-scoring game, and the pressure went to Mac, and he answered. Now the quarterback right here for Alabama is going to be under his first pressurized drive as a starter.
So they run it on first down, and they get nothing. Nice play by Mahmoud Diabate.
Also, Brenton Cox. Number one, he crashed from that outside defensive end spot and cleaned it up for Diabate to make the play.
Alabama going a little tempo, or at least they're showing it. Whether or not they snap it quickly, we'll see. Second and 10. And now there's motion all over the place. Going to be second and 15, it looks like.
The one big difference, well, I'm going to give you two big differences for Mac Jones last year and Bryce Young this year. One, there wasn't 90,000 people on the stands.
That's right.
Number two, the Ole Miss defense is not as good as the Florida defense.
Good point. Good 2 points. Now, this snap count or the clap count or something was messed up here because half the line took off. At least the receivers all did. Only guy that kept it was the center.
Well, I thought he clapped. Maybe the only guy didn't hear it was the center.
Well, I can see why.
They're going to have to go to silent count. It's too noisy, and they do.
Throw to the middle is on target to Mechie. Trey Dean brought him down as he got it to the 30, maybe the 31.
Mechie in the stack over here comes right across into the middle, wide open area to throw to, and he sticks it right in there.
Big third down on the opening series of the quarter for Alabama here, and even bigger for the Florida defense in this group. And they pick up the first down and then some. Brian Robinson still going. Out across the 40 to the 43.
So that's one of those calls Bill O'Brien just made right there. If it doesn't work, the Alabama Nation will be going, what was that? Nice job by Del Condon, time number 71, the center. He might have missed the snap count, but he got the block on the next play.
First down at the 43. Now Young back to the air. Across the middle. Oh, what a catch by Williams. And he's still running. Puts a fake on a man inside the 30 and backpedals to the 28.
Well, you made the call. Williams that time is going full speed in one area. And by the way, for him, full speed is fast.
Yeah.
And the ball is behind him, and he adjusts right there. Well, nice job turning and catching it at the same time.
Now they're down to the 28-yard line on that 29-yard pickup. First down. Quick throw. Slade Bolden gets drilled for a loss.
So that's how, excuse me there, Ness, that's how Alabama started the game, and Trevor Johnson got blocked on the play. He didn't that time. Again, getting more used to the tempo of playing against Alabama than the first two games that they played.
Boy, this is a form tackle right here. Bolden almost caught the ball out of there. Second down and 12. That guy's scared.
Sending the running back out to the right. Bryce Young knows it's zone defense because he's got a cornerback on him at the top of the screen. So he knows he's got a zone coverage.
Here comes a blitz. Young fires. Had it knocked down by Brenton Cox, who almost picked it off.
So a zone look, but they drop the defensive end. That's something a young quarterback won't see very often. Watch him drop inside, and the linebacker comes in. Still a four-man rush, but right in the line. A wonderful call by Todd Grantham on that play.
Yeah, well done by Brenton Cox, who had a sack earlier, and now that pass breakup, and it's third down and 12. Into the eyes of the Alabama quarterback, Bryce Young. First road start. Feeling a little bit of the heat now, and they're bringing the heat. Young down the seam, almost picked off by Elam, and a flag.
Yeah, it's going to be pass interference on the play.
And Cox is back there with Mechie.
Pass interference, defense number one. Penalty places the ball at the spot of the foul and concludes an automatic first down.
So you got a guy that made a play and almost had an interception, and then he's back there covering on Mechie.
Yeah, same thing, only this time his job is to take it from the, not come inside, but go collision the receiver. But it was a quick pass. Had it not been a quick pass, he'd have got away with it. NFL, you can't do it, but college, you can.
Mechie's not going to remember that one or not forget that one. Robinson keeps his balance, and he gets it to the 16. This guy waited his turn, shared some reps with Najee Harris. He may not be Najee, but there's not a lot of Najees out there, but this guy's pretty darn good. Second down at 5. And whistles and flags. For the false start, we'll back him up outside the 20.
Even going silent count was not anticipated well, or maybe anticipated a little bit too much. And number 55, Eck, you're on the play.
Alabama still having a little bit of trouble running.
You can almost tell it's silent count because the guard next to the center will turn around and look at the quarterback to see when he lifts his foot, and then that sound starts the count. See him turning around to look. Once he lifts his foot, then he goes, okay.
Young. Heavy pressure that time, and he throws it in the dirt and complete.
That wasn't very clean that time either. That ball was snapped. Mike Cohen was still giving signals on the play. Watch this. He's turning around giving signals, and then all of a sudden, the ball is snapped. He didn't even see what was going on, and his man made the play. That was not good execution of the silent clown.
Third down and 10. And he to get to the 12-yard line for a first down. Jace McClellan in the backfield. He's got a touchdown today. He's with Bryce Young. Young fires complete. The tight end, Latu, did he get it?
He stretched the ball out. This might be reviewed.
The spot they gave him, I don't know. It's going to be short, the spot they gave him, I think.
I know, but watch him stick the ball out as he gets tackled. See that?
Yeah, that should be a first down.
I think this should be reviewed, and I think it's going to be a first down.
I do, too.
Watch when his knee comes out. You can see him looking at the down marker and stretching the ball out at the same time.
Great awareness by Latu, the tight end. Alex Moore is our referee. Our replay officials, David Allman. And Alex going to trot all the way down. Here's another look. You see they have to get right to the 12-yard line. And Gene Steratore is along with us, our rules expert in New York. Gino, what do you think?
You said it, Brad. A great play by Latu. We can see that his right knee hits the ground, and as it is hitting the ground, the extension with both hands on that football gets it over the line to gain. It's a great play by Latu, and I think after review, as you guys had said, they'll have a first down.
Latu had a great game in the opener against the Hurricanes. Caught a couple of touchdown passes, and that's going to be a big play, too, if indeed it is a chain mover.
His first year at Alabama, he played defensive end.
Wow.
Dover to the tight end. Took him a little while to get accustomed to it. I'm sure he played both in high school,
yep.
Right?
So the review underway. Call on the field again was short. And we think this was an easy one. Here's a call.
The review. The receiver made the line to gain by getting the ball to the 12-yard line. Therefore, it would be first down.
First down, Alabama at the 12.
So I even think on that call, the importance of this game with the crowd in it, say it was a challenge type play, I think that would even deserve a challenge. You know, everything gets reviewed in the college game, especially these line to gain right here, but I think that would have been challenged no matter what. That was pretty obvious from the press box.
So the drive stays alive when they had Alabama in a couple of third down situations. They can still get another first down without getting to the end zone.
Bill O'Brien seems to be managing Bryce Young very carefully and smartly on this drive. They seem in sync.
McClellan behind Young from the 12 will get the carry. Straight up the middle to the 10. That's all. Jeremiah Moon in on the tackle.
You know, those inside runs, as you mentioned before, that was gashed this Florida defense a year ago. Okay, as you said, the transfers that got them bigger inside. You got to cut off the middle, as Todd told us yesterday. Todd Grantham said, if you don't stop the middle of the run attack, you'll get it every time.
Second and 8 from the 10. Bolden in a slot. Mechie is over there on the left side with him. Young wants to go the other way. Now to the end zone, and Bolden dropped it. He was wide open.
Wow, how about that read by Bryce Young? He starts to the right side. He goes 1-2 to the right and then comes back and quickly finds it. It's going to go out and into the middle. He's wide open, but he's looking right, looks left, got him. And he delivers it almost exactly as he sees it. What a play. And boy, you don't want to drop one like that.
Third down and 8. Latu, the tight end's back in there now. That's Williams in motion toward the snap. Young pressured. Cox had a hand on him. Throws on the run, completes it. McClellan, he's got the first down, I think. He says he does. I agree. Moon made the tackle. Should be first and goal inside the 2.
Watch 2 full games of Bryce Young and then watch him again today. The guy does not like to run when he scrambles. He's such a weapon after that first wave passes him by to stay downfield and pick the next best receiver. His style, I want to be very careful with him. His style of play reminds me of the way Russell Wilson used to play when he was in college.
Right.
Russell used to make those plays smartly, head downfield all the time. Now, Russell's gotten bigger and richer. He's got that type of feel when he plays quarterback.
They're reviewing whether or not he got the first down here.
This is going to be close the other way, in my opinion. When his backside comes down, it seems like the ball is short of the line to me.
So another review going on here. Take another look from our AT&T 5G pylon cam, as McClellan has already scored once into our pylon cam today. Stretching it out, just trying to get first down here. You start looking at that, it looks like it's 2.5 yards out on his rear end hitting the turf. But
is that right? Can't tell.
No, not nope. Really.
I thought the other one, when I went out on a limb right here, I thought this one, when he's down right there, I thought he was slightly short. Now, I don't know if it's obvious because it was called the first down on the field.
Right. And so again, second time on this drive, we get the call, and here it is.
After review, the receiver was short of the line of gain. The ball was placed on the 2-yard line for the fourth down.
So, Gene, that one's overturned.
It is, and I think the difference between what we see McClellan do and what Latu did, McClellan has to protect the ball in that situation, guys. He didn't have the opportunity to stretch that football. Protection of the football was more important at that time, and now we've got one heck of a fourth down and inches to go.
You said it, my friend. Fourth and inches.
Well, Bill O'Brien spent many years in New England coaching Tom Brady, and in this situation, they'd go sneak.
The trail man will walk in. Brian Robinson, touchdown, Alabama.
Florida loads the inside, and as Ness said, the edge was not manned, and it was a walk-in. brought in the extra tackle. Kendall Randolph, number 85, is actually a tackle slash, you know, three tackle guy, and he comes in at tight end, and they just smash it down.
For Alabama.
Extra point by Reichard coming up. Reichard up and right through the middle. So just when Florida had gone 75 yards to make it a five-point game, what an answer for the Tide. Brian Robinson, three-yard touchdown. It's 28-16 Alabama.
Hey.
Don't forget, coming up later in the game, we'll have our play of the game presented by Jersey Mike Subs. The play of that last drive, Brian Robinson's three-yard scoring run, and it was Jameson Williams with a 28-yard pass play from Bryce Young, and then going for it on fourth down.
Right. You know, other big plays, I mean, penalty, you know, by Cox on the play. Latu the ball out there. Yeah. You know, the dump off McClellan. He gets down there to inches. A lot of big plays. A lot of clutch plays by the Alabama team on that drive.
Jamarcus Weston. Back deep. Awaiting Will Reichard's kick. And fair catch. Taken, bobbled, and out to the 25 comes Florida. Invesco brings you today's scholar athletes for Alabama, Chris Owens, and for Florida, Jeremiah Moon. Invesco proud to support student athletes on and off the field with a donation of $1,000 to Alabama and Florida's general scholarship funds. Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, Jamie Erdahl, and our CBS crew in Gainesville, Florida. Threat of rain is getting a little bit darker. We hope that stays away.
Yeah, this ball's going to the 1 yard line because that ball was muffed on a fair catch.
Oh, boy.
And it rolled out to the 1 yard line. Remember, the receiver could just let it go. And if it hits the end zone, it's a touchback. By trying to catch it, it gets it at the half yard line. Now, if the ball would have rolled in the field, it would have been a live ball to recover as well.
Here's Jamarcus Weston.
Yep.
There's the fair catch call, and then he just drops it.
And then he lets it go. Watch the official. He lets it go, and he watches, Then he stops it. Just think if that ball would have bounced because Weston thinks it's a touchback.
He thinks it's a dead ball there.
Yes.
That's not the spot that Florida's offense wanted to start in. With Emory Jones being planted, his feet planted in his own end zone. See if they can get just something to get him some breathing room here. He's got Naquan Wright with him in the backfield. Emory Jones will take the snap about 6 yards deep here. Going to throw, wants to, and short arm that a little bit, incomplete.
So if you're Alabama right now, Pete Golden, I'm sure Nick Saban is in his ear and say, you get a three and out here, we could put this game away with our field position. We get back whatever you got. Let's keep our best guys in. Give me your best three defensive calls on this, and we could score points with our defense right here.
There's Pete, defensive coordinator for Alabama. I said Emory Jones is in a bad spot. I wouldn't want to be a lineman here either. You don't want to get caught holding down in this spot. Four-man front shifting for Alabama. Emory Jones flares it out, and that one's incomplete.
Oh, he threw a bad one. See, you got to get those are 5 big yards for Florida right there. Got to pull the string on another easy throw. You know, he had an easy throw in the first half that he missed, then he came back from it. But this one,
that's just in the dirt.
No, that was a bouncer.
Third down and 10 from their own 1 yard line for Florida. Just when they were hoping they could get good field position and try to answer Alabama's scoring drive, they find themselves in this spot.
Last time with empty, they went quarterback draw. Will they come back with that? Nope, I'll let them throw.
And he completed it, and it's a first down and then some. Naquan Wright, whoa, what a clutch play that was.
So what threw off this Alabama defense was putting the running back to the wide side. You see Job, he's signaling zone defense because he's on the running back, but inside, Helms does not react and make the tackle to save the first down. Gutsy call, good throw, and got off the end of the line here. Now remember that last drive, Jones did it with a little bit of running and option. That got it going for him. Let's see if they come back to the option.
18-yard pickup when they desperately needed it on third down, and now it's first down. He stands in the pocket's got all day, throws, and Wells was open. The throw was a little bit late, and it was nearly intercepted by Moore back there.
Yeah, a little bit late and about 5 to 10 yards short on the throw. Great protection on the play. Three-man rush. He waits. He's got him right to the sideline, and it just dies out. You see Wells kind of have to stop and go to his knees for it, and could have been a big play.
Yep. Second down and 10 from the 19 with 3.5 remaining in the quarter. Straight up the middle. Naquan Wright, one of the fastest Gators, and he's all the way out near midfield. So two big plays for number 6 here in the last couple of minutes.
Well, Helms, number 2, the safety, came up to the outside. See him, number 2, right there to the side. He came to the outside, and once they broke the line of scrimmage, no safety to make the play.
The man down for the Gators.
Is it Gamble?
Back at the 18-yard line, it is Gamble. Damari Gamble will check on him in a minute.
With direct.
Damari Gamble headed to the medical tent. Had some really big receptions in this game, but he was hurt blocking on Brian Young, number 47.
Yeah, he's lined up to the right, and he comes across, turns his left shoulder, and that's where he gets, as Ness said, a stinger. Let's hope it's just that. Nothing more serious.
Paramount Plus is the new home of Inside the NFL. Get expert insight, exclusive commentary, and special features from the hardest team of analysts in football. Catch new episodes Tuesdays at 9:30 Eastern exclusively on Paramount Plus. Well, a couple big plays by number 6, an 18-yard reception by Naquan Wright, a 30-yard run. And here they are at the 49-yard line for the first down. Cuts it outside. He's got another good gainer, and still going is Naquan Wright.
I mean, this is a pretty impressive drive, I'll tell you this time.
It's the Naquan Wright drive right now.
Got it. The pass off the on third down, got it started. That offensive line sticks with their guys, and Wright looks like he's going to go down and refuses to.
Just outside the 35 of Alabama. First and 10 for Florida. And now another gash on the ground, and Naquan Wright is having some kind of career just on this drive.
Well, and you got to feel that offensive line right now feels like they can block him, and they are. The Lance, number 56, at the point of attack, handles him, turns him, and opens it for Wright to get into the secondary again.
6 carries, 62 yards on this drive, and the 18-yard reception.
I'll tell you, really good play here by center Ekwokon, number 65. He's doing a brilliant job with that nose.
And that time he got fed one time too many. Brian Young made the tackle, loss on the play.
Just beats him across the head. Could not get it down that time. DeLance made a good block on the last one, but Young was too quick of him, guessed the snap count or whatever, but he was there. Got right across the face of DeLance that time. The tackle blew up the play.
Damian Pierce now in at tailback, giving Naquan Wright a breather. Rick Wells in motion on a second down at 14. Emory Jones, option, will keep it. Good gain. Byron Young again around on the tackle, brings up third down and about 9.
They're only 2 for 9 on third down, but the last one was big.
Yeah.
Number 2 was big.
Look at the numbers rushing.
For sure.
Well, Florida came in as the number one rushing team in the country, but quite honestly, a lot of that was their two quarterbacks. But right now, Naquan Wright and Pierce and Malik Davis are all doing their work on the ground.
And the threat of the option has spread out that defense.
39, Jones going for a back shoulder throw. He got it at the 4-yard line of Xavier Henderson.
And that one was by design. That was not a poor throw. That was a perfect throw. Bump and run coverage. The receiver has eyes on it. The defensive back, Emory Davis, doesn't. Perfect execution. Like to know how many times teams have gone 99 yards against Nick Saban.
Maybe like never. I don't know. Right now, they're 5 yards away from it. First and goal. Empty backfield. This be an Emory Jones run. They got all the receivers to the right. And the run is Emory Jones up the middle. Did he get there? Touchdown, Florida. What a drive.
And think about the mental toughness from Emory Jones. That second down pass when he skipped it. And then he comes back and does it on third down. He runs the options. They get the running game going. The back shoulder throw, and he finishes the drive himself.
Extra point for Howard upcoming. Up and good. Remember, this all started with a muffed fair catch with the ball bouncing out of bounds at the 1-yard line. The official right on the spot, we said, oh boy, this is not what you want. But if you go 99 yards in 11 plays in a little over 4 minutes, and then number 5 scores from 5, and the lead is cut to 5. Both quarterbacks in their own special way putting on a show right now with 29 seconds remaining. And here's the comparison. And Emory Jones's numbers are getting better and better. Bryce Young has come down to earth a little bit from the opening 3 drives of the ball game. But now we got a game.
And remember, Emory, as well as the passing, has ran for over 60 yards. And he's dealing the option for extra yards as well. Got this Alabama defense off balance.
Williams will bring it out from a yard deep. Jameson Williams gets tagged at about the 28, got maybe to the 29-yard line. Next Saturday, college football doubleheader on CBS. We'll start things off at noon Eastern with a Mountain West matchup between Boise State and Utah State. Then at 3:30, SEC on CBS features number 7 Texas A&M, 20th-ranked Arkansas in Arlington. We'll be at Jerry's World. It's full afternoon of college football next Saturday on CBS. I'm sure Jerry Jones will be there, being an Arkansas alum.
That's why the game's there. You got it.
Well, he's a busy guy.
Well, not for Arkansas, I don't think.
First down.
Don't we love these back and forth games? We love to watch the pressure on both teams to execute.
Short gain on the run. McClellan still isn't down. I think the whistle's blown.
Well, I have to be honest, this is the best I've seen Brenton Cox play in his career, number one. A lot of people question, he's a big-time recruit. He was really identified by Alabama as one of Nick Saban's most important recruits. Went to Georgia, transferred to Florida, and today he has shown up.
We played 3 in the swamp. They're fired up. They're waiting for Tom Petty's Don't Back Down. They're not backing down. 28-23. To within 5 as we start the fourth quarter at the Swamp in Gainesville. Bryce Young, quick throw over the middle, complete. JoJo Earl in the open field. And a nice gain, picked up about 11 yards. This is what we were hoping for, partner, a rematch of SEC championship game. Different faces. Both teams kind of doing the same thing.
The last four drives, Florida scored three times, put over 260 yards. Dan Mullen has found his rhythm. He's got a running quarterback, just a good enough passer, and he's keeping this Alabama defense off balance. Now, if you're Alabama, you're going, hey, our defense is struggling. We got to help them. We got to
get some more points.
It's just like the SEC championship game all over again.
That one ended up 52 to 46. We probably aren't going to get that high today in the point total, but it's giving you that feel a little bit. Empty backfield for Bryce Young. On the Gator 47, has time. Flush, throws on the run, and throws incomplete.
And he got out of the pocket. That'll be not called intentional grounding.
Had some pressure, and now he faces third down and seven. McClellan goes out. Brian Robinson, the veteran, back in. Third down and seven. High snap. Young fires deep in the middle, broken up. Intended for Mechie. Knocked out of there by Helm.
Flag is down, though. Get him early? Was it a grab of the jersey? I don't know. Yeah, he had his arm on the backside of him, tugging him from behind.
There's that left hand coming around the shoulder.
Yep, just before the ball got there.
Yep. That's a good call.
Tight coverage, good coverage. Jazz, you see, he hits his head, his hands to his head, just, you know, a fraction early with everything.
So first down by penalty, just inside the Gator 35. Last time Florida scored a touchdown, Alabama came back with an answer of their own, and now it's Brian Robinson hit in the backfield, dropped at the line of scrimmage. Dexter made the play.
I think they're going to be 12 men on defense here for Florida. Might be why they stopped them.
It's going to be the third time we've had that call, twice against Florida, once against Alabama.
Yep. This one's, you know, sometimes there's substitutions going on, but again, 4-4-4. Four up front, four linebackers, and four defensive backs.
Don't put that pressure on me to ask what that comes to.
I gave you the easy one, right?
He gave me the layup.
Yep.
First down and five at the 29. Mechie comes in motion across the field. Handoff straight inside. Good 3 yard run by Robinson. Brian Robinson.
Workhorse, this time just going up. Latu comes right up the middle. It follows the tight end. His angle on the middle linebacker that time, Hopper. And just a little bit of a push because of the penalty on first down. They're able to just pound it. Take some clock and put points on the board is what they'd like to right now for Alabama.
Second down and two. Play action. Young. Gonna run finally. And he's got a first down and quite a bit more. Gets inside the 20.
Seems like he has a sense when running the football from the quarterback position is worthwhile. You only need 3 yards to get a first down. He's got the first down. Why not take it? Don't need to force anything in here. And then goes head first.
Back in the red zone at the 19. And back to the ground and the veteran, Brian Robinson, who had close to 500 yards rushing a year ago when he would spell Najee Harris. And today he's starting to get things warmed up a little bit. Emory Jones can only look on right now with a headset, hoping his defense can get a stop or that he can get the ball back for the offense quickly. 12 minutes and change remaining in the ballgame. Quick throw in the flat. Out to Mechie. Mechie a flag down. I think we're going to have an illegal block out there, maybe on Latu.
It is. Just enough of a grab to catch the attention. It was on helm number 24 that time. No need, but he went out and reached and got caught.
We apologize. We're having some trouble with the referees, Mike, but you're going to see it here. Gary's going to show you.
RPO. He's got the edge, and just enough of a tug. Got his arm and then a little bit of his face mask, it looked like,
yep.
too.
There you go. Raked across the face mask and the jersey. So Latu, who had a big play on their touchdown drive, keeping a drive alive, sets them back a little bit on this one. Robinson split out as a wide receiver now to the bottom of your screen. So it's an empty backfield, but it's a quick wide receiver screen to Mechie, who spins his way, keeps his footing, knocked out of bounds by Brenton Cox. They have a couple of words on the sideline. Friendly banter, I guess, at the 12. They're down at 3. Young fakes and shovels it to Latu, and he's down first and goal inside the 2.
See what I'm saying about the Russell Wilson stuff?
Yes, exactly.
I mean, this play did not go exactly well. The play-action pass was kind of sloppy. Then he's got a guy in his face, maneuvers, and then keeps his poise and just delivers the ball like a point guard or a second baseman or something, right? I mean, beautiful, just calm, 90,000 people, big drive. That's why this guy was the chosen one almost,
yep.
right?
First and goal. High formation backfield. Robinson the tail. Didn't get there. Nice job by Florida. I think it was Moon maybe that got in there. I think Diabate made the play.
Nobody gets blown off the line of scrimmage. Ron Dexter, number 9, was there. Carter was there. And then cleaned up by Diabate, as Brad told you.
Second down and goal. Everybody packed in tight on both lines. Robinson, the tailback in the eye. They fake it to him. Young pumps, throws, and had it tipped.
Oh,
and did Mechie catch it? He's out of bounds. It was Latu, not Mechie, but it was tipped. And incomplete.
Here's one where, you know, from up here, we thought he was going to run it in. He saw one more potential throw, and it gets broken up, trying to dish it short, and just tipped short when he had, just because of the tip, that slowed it down enough that Latu's momentum took him out of bounds. Great play by Torrance, number 22, to save a touchdown.
Our 5G pylon cam out of bounds. McClellan in there, a tailback, and he doesn't get there either. It's fourth and goal.
Remember, a field goal makes it an 8-point game.
Offense staying on the field for Alabama. Just outside the 1.
How about that? You come in there, you take that on head on. Bernie, number 2, the inside linebacker, stops it.
They've got their receivers spread out everywhere. 2 to each side.
Timeout Florida. They didn't have anybody covered to the outside.
Gonna say there's 2 guys up there,
yep.
all by themselves. Talk about your lonely ends. Fourth and goal when we come back. The Crimson Tide at the 1-yard line with a 4th down and goal. They got 3 touchdowns early. Florida has battled back. Alabama's last touchdown came on a 4th and 1 from the 3. This is 4th and goal from the 1. And it's an empty backfield except for number 9, Bryce Young.
The box is heavy right now.
Here comes Ryan Robinson to join him, though.
Florida's playing the run.
Everybody moved. All start Alabama. And I give that one to the crowd, at least partially.
Well, a lot was going on. And when Bryce Young came right come up there and says, it's a loaded box, they're forcing me to pass, he had to change the play. And that's where Ness was right. The crowd got involved and nobody could hear the play. An illegal procedure.
Will Reichard's only missed one field goal in his career at Alabama. It came last week from 34 yards out. This one's from 24. And it's up and good. So there's your 8-point game that Gary talked about. With 9:25 remaining. Bryce Young leads them down for a field goal, and they're up by 8. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by State Farm. Buffalo Wild Wings. AT&T. And by GMC. Alabama gets a field goal on the last drive after going 64 yards and 14 plays. One blown lead under Nick Saban of 18 or more points. And that was the comeback game that you did, Gary, with Byrne. That was something special.
That was.
And this game has become special, too. It sure didn't look like it in the first quarter when Alabama scored 3 straight touchdowns.
And you're thinking what Nick Saban and Pete Golding, the defensive coordinator for Alabama, can dial up to slow down this running game for Florida. Just enough runs where the passing game is working really well.
Right. Coming up after our game, Adam, Rick, and BJ with the day's best highlights of the College Football Postgame Show, presented by Rocket Mortgage. They're getting it to the guys. 9 minutes and 25 seconds of game clock time, but this is in regulation because we've got an 8-point game.
And the thing that really helps with that stop down there, obviously the difference in points, but now for calling plays for Dan Mullen, he can just take his time. One drive is all he needs. Every play on his sheet is still available to him. No hurry up needed.
Whittemore in motion. Henry Jones to take the snap. He's played a whale of a game. He rolls the throw, dumps it short. Complete zipper, and he zips out there for first down at the 38.
You know, sometimes not having the second guy behind you, knowing that you're going to get pulled out after every mistake, you can make a mistake, settle down, and make another nice play. And remember, Emory Jones, a highly recruited player, originally committed to Ohio State, and then when Dan came, switched to Florida.
Now he does it with his legs here. Emory Jones, first down run, pickup of about 15.
Yes, I told you this before. When I turned on the tape after reading how bad Emory was, I was surprised how many good plays he made. Yeah, he made some bad ones, but these good plays make him a huge weapon in this offense.
He's only really made one, as you look at Anthony Richardson on the sidelines. He's only made really one bad play. It was the interception when he got leveled trying to throw it.
Inaccurate throws, but true. I think that's just part of his game. You're going to have to live with that.
There's some movement up there. And Will Anderson says it's a false start on the
false
Gators.
Start. Offense number 56.
And we have our referee's mic working now.
So first down.
That is the call. As I talked over the top of him. Sorry, ref.
I do that to you. It's no big deal.
So they back it up. Back into Gator land at the 47.
Man, 4 straight drives. One punt in the last 4. The 99-yarder, one of them, are averaging over 8 yards a play. This is the 5th drive in a row that they've kept this Alabama defense off balance.
Malik Davis got dropped for a loss.
Jeez, number 31.
How many number 31s are there? Let's check in with Jamie.
Well, you're looking at a right side of the offensive line for Florida, who at the beginning of this game, Dan Mullen said, was very experienced. Gene DeLance went down, and then Stuart Reese went down. DeLance was able to come back in, but Josh Braun is still on that right side. Guys, also, in that last offensive series when Kamar Gamble got hurt, he actually got cut on the left side of his face. He got stitched up. He has his helmet, and he is available.
And on top of that, as you can see with Jamie, the rain is starting to fall here in Gainesville. And the ball just fell as well, and it's Will Anderson again.
Oh, my God.
Gee whiz.
When I talked to defensive coordinator Pete Golding, I said, is number 31 going to play? He goes, you cannot keep this guy off the field. He is just a different type of cat.
They call him the Terminator. I can see why. He got his knee whipped last week.
He showed flashes a year ago, but he's bigger.
Yeah.
You know, 10, 15 pounds bigger, more experienced. Going all over the field this time. Now he's lining up on the right side.
Third down and a whole bunch for Florida. They're 8-19, and here comes a blitz. Anderson's one of them. He gets to Jones, but Jones delivers. They're about a yard or two shy. Whittemore made the tackle, but he had to hit the turf to make the catch.
So it was a zone blitz, heavy from one side, but only four men rushing because they dropped number 20. Middle of the field is wide open. I think that's some poor spreading out for that. And hurry up on fourth down.
Lob it out, Whittemore. I don't know. The official might give him a good spot right there. That should be a first down.
Let's see when he reached the ball out. Was it after he was down or not?
It's called a... It is not... They haven't made a decision yet. I was going to say they're moving the sticks, but maybe they're not. They're moving the chain.
So he reaches it out, but he brings it back when his knee comes down. Be interesting... If the line is accurate, I think, if I was a replay official, I would take a look at this. Are they going to get it off?
Too late.
He's holding good.
Malik Davis backpedaling his way down to the 31-yard line. Still going, actually.
So it's not like the end zone where you just break the goal line and it counts. You have to finish the play.
Gene, that was a hurry-up situation. What do you think, Gene Steratore?
You know, even though the knee isn't down, though, when we do reach like that, a runner reaches like that, he gets all of what he can get. And even though his knee isn't down and he reaches that ball, that is still his forward progress. So if the knee goes down later than that, he gets all that he reached for, and it's a good ruling of a first down because of that reach.
Even though he brings it back himself?
Yes, Gary, because he brings it back himself, but in that run, while he's still an upright runner and legal, what he reaches for, he gets the furthest most
you
point.
Got it. Thanks for clarifying.
It would be the same as if he would be driven backward on a forward progress play.
Thanks for clarifying, because it was close. Thank you.
So first down on the Emory Jones run to the 28-yard line. 5 minutes left in regulation. Play defensively there.
DJ Dale, I think that time, wasn't it? The nose tackle. Have not heard a lot from him. Been handled pretty well inside. Usually he's taken two gaps, but this time he kind of shifts to the outside, slants wide, and ends up making the play.
So Malik Davis lost three.
Instead of lining up over the center that time, he lined up at defensive tackle and then slanted out.
Here's now at a tailback. Three wide receivers to Emory Jones right. Now they empty the backfield. Jones over the middle. He's liked that spot today, and he's liked number 14 a few times. Whittemore. That makes the third down a little more manageable.
This time Henry Toa in the middle is looking all different directions. He looks right, then he comes up, and he leaves the area that's wide open in the middle and thrown right off his helmet on the play. I don't know what he was looking at. It was almost a... like an offensive lineman he saw move.
Now Dan Mullen can call two plays here. It's under 4 minutes. It's third down and six. It's four down territory, right?
You got it. I think he's going to go all the way with this drive. No way he's just kicking for a field goal now.
Third down and six. Blitz over the middle again complete. That one's to Zipper. First down, Florida.
So this was too easy. This was a gimme. Once he reads the blitz, he knows he's got him coming off the slot. Safety's trying to disguise. Helms is deep. Once the player lined up over the receiver, he knows he's got him. He just throws where the blitzer leaves. It's an easy first down.
Florida with the answer have worked their way into the red zone of the 17. First down. Off the left side, bouncing it out is Pierce. He's gone. Touchdown, Florida. Thank you.
Malachi Moore, number 13, thought he got held on the play, but not called. And remember, Florida has to go for two here because of the missed extra point early on the touchdown.
Who knows? This might be the ball game right here, even though there's almost 3 minutes remaining. Malik Davis says to Emory Jones, what's the call from the three? Two-point conversion. They ride it, they ride it, they push it. Davis didn't get there. So the two-point conversion fails.
Not quite sure why the clock is running there. That's a after a point after try. I think they're going to have to reset the game clock on this play. Dan Mullen noticed it right away, too. It was point after touchdown. Clock should have stopped. I'm not exactly sure when the touchdown was scored, but as you can see, it continued. It can't turn it off.
It's still going.
Yeah, the off button's not working.
Nick Saban's defense holds on the two-point conversion.
Yep, the game clock just keeps going. And there was two.
Please reset the game clock to 3 minutes and 10 seconds. Thank you.
3 minutes and 10 seconds means with two timeouts, Florida has to hold them. If two, probably two first downs would do it for Alabama.
Actually, when he scored the touchdown, I wrote down 303 on my pad here, but apparently I was already still running after I wrote that down. So 310. He's whistling. Hey, how about the clock?
He saw the clock running. It should have stopped after the touchdown. That took it from, what, 220 back to over 3 minutes.
310 remaining. Two-point game. Florida's last three drives are all touchdowns, and they're still short a couple. That we do, Adam. Alabama expecting an onside kick. Slade Bolden is the only guy back deep around the 20-yard line. Florida's got two timeouts remaining. They failed on the two-point conversion on the untimed play. They're going to kick away. They missed an extra point earlier in the ballgame, and we might have a tie right now. As it is, it goes all the way to the end zone. It'll bring it out to the 25.
So here's the problem if you're Bill O'Brien. You know, your quarterback is your playmaker. In this situation, one, probably two first downs. I said one first down goes a long way with the timeouts and the clock. But Alabama's not been able to run it. 70 yards all game. And remember, down on the goal line, and they could have put it away running the ball.
Yep.
They could not do it.
Now the Florida players asking for some noise. Zach Carter leading the cheers down on the defensive line. Alabama comes out with Brian Robinson with Bryce Young in the backfield. Metchie and Williams, the wide receiver. Slade Bolden, the slot man. And here we go. They can get Coach Saban off the field. Latu's a tight end who just switched sides. First down from the 25. Robinson. Got maybe three. And now the clock is not running.
Did Florida take the timeout?
Well, they had to be some time off the clock.
We're currently having an issue with the game clock.
Oh,
the time will be kept on the field. There's 2 minutes and 59 seconds remaining in the game.
What a revelation that is, that we're having issues with the clock.
Right. So this is difficult for Dan. He has to stay right with that side official and know exactly the amount of time on the clock the whole time, because he can't depend on the clock on the scoreboard.
We've got an injured Gator as well. With 2:59, we think, remaining. Arizona Power got kind of rolled up in the pile at the end of that last play that went untimed again due to the clock situation. As you can see, Robinson with the run and the game clock never started.
Right, and during the commercial, Nick Saban wants to know, okay, did Florida take a timeout, or are we going to wind the clock and get 40 seconds after the first down play?
He's saying they have to do one or the other. They have two timeouts
right.
remaining.
They still, as
they still
as
have
we
two
know,
timeouts, right?
We still got them as two. So that means the clock will be wound by the referee, and they'll get a full 40 seconds of runoff, taking it down to, you know, 220.
Let's see if that's the case. Boy, a game like this, the magnitude of this, and then you have in our day of electronics an electronic problem that has both coaches sort of steaming, has the fans wondering, and has CBS in a two-point game.
And even though that was a three-yard run, it wasn't clean. It was a push. It was stopped up really well by that front seven for Florida.
Well, they're not running out. Bryce Young says, I thought they were going to do something with the clock.
Well, since the clock on the scoreboard isn't working, he has to look at the play clock to know how long he's gone. That seems...
Play clock is working.
And
so Jerry
can see that on the field.
Right. So just do your math down there. Take the 259.
Around 220-ish when the snap. Well,
yeah, right in there. But he's got to look to the sideline because he doesn't really have any way of knowing. I'm sure he's got the go-ahead now. Let's snap it. And let's not get a penalty. And they do. Robinson, a couple yards shy of the first down, be third.
And this should be a timeout by Florida right here. He's going to hang.
All right, well, we'd love to tell you exactly how much time is on the game clock, but it's going to be around...
It's going to be under 2 minutes now.
Right, 140 maybe?
Yep, when they snap, the next one is going to be around 140.
Meanwhile, Chase McClellan comes back in at tailback for Alabama on a huge third down.
Went left both times. Alabama's going to take a timeout.
Yep. Got a quarterback in his first year as a starter on the road in front of 90,000 screaming at him, and they want to make sure he knows what's coming up on the next play. Those of you just joining us, a minute 36 remaining in a two-point game, third down and two, Alabama. The game clock is at least showing us 1:36. That is the official time. We don't know if it's going to run when the time comes on this next play. And it'll begin on the snap.
Same situation down on the goal line when Alabama could not stick it in to put the game away.
Ryan Robinson in the backfield. Bryce Young under center will give it to him, and he got the first down. A huge first down on a day when Alabama has struggled on the ground. They give it to their veteran tailback, Brian Robinson.
Came back the other way. Nice athletic play by number 55, Ekiyar, on that one. He stepped outside. The defender went inside, and he adjusted and got just enough of him to make it a positive play. So another 40 seconds will go off, so we're under a minute
right
before Dan can take a timeout.
Now they go with that eye backfield that they use down on the goal line. McClellan, who's had a big day today, has a big run here. Got it to the 40. And a timeout.
Now the game clock will now change, and it'll go down by about 50 seconds.
Dear remaining, Florida, they put it back to 58. They changed it a couple of times while we were away.
So let's say this play takes 5 seconds. So you're to 53, and then you subtract 40 seconds. No, there won't be. There'll be a timeout. But after third down, you'll get 40 seconds. So you're under 15 seconds left in the game if there's a fourth down play.
Right now, it's second down, and it's almost six. And a pistol backfield with McClellan behind Young. McClellan cuts back in the middle of the field. Only got about a yard. So it's third down at four. Vogel made the stop for the Gators defense. Well, we got a quick timeout here. Time for our GMC game changer today. And even if they lose, this guy was pretty special, Emory Jones. Gary said, had the crowd looking over his shoulder, another quarterback looking over his shoulder, and he handled the pressure pretty well today.
He did. Sometimes not having that guy trotting in, you can just handle a mistake. It's like those guys that shoot the threes in basketball. Yeah, I missed five. I'm due.
Yeah, I'm going to keep shooting.
Yep.
There's what he's done. 76 on the ground and a touchdown. Almost 200 in the air.
So right now, if you're Alabama, I wonder if you even hand the ball off here. Do you just let the quarterback kind of roll and buy time as much as you can? Anything but a fumble here, and Alabama should be able to put the game away. Maybe punt with a few seconds, or sometimes they throw the high pass to end the game.
The crowd trying their best for their defense. I'm sure they're confused by the game clock. We just saw a big bolt of lightning over to our right. That's what it would take for Florida maybe to get the ball back, a bolt of lightning. McClellan cuts back in the middle of the field. He gets buried. He's at least 2 yards, almost 3 yards shy of the first down, and it's fourth down.
Game clock is now good. It's separated by about 9 seconds. So Alabama has a timeout that they can run it all the way down and decide what to do.
I think if I read the lips of Nick Saban, he just said he's going to call timeout to the umpire, but we'll see. They have two remaining. Florida has none, obviously. You know, both teams said we're going to find out what we're made of today.
Both.
They both have.
They have. I mean, as much as sometimes in a win, Nick Saban will get on his football team, I can bet you he won't in this. He will salute them to the fight it was and how they survived it.
It's funny, Todd Grantham was with Nick as a defensive coach when he was at Michigan State. And
correct.
You said, was he happy after a win? He said, heck no, up there. He was a lot happier after a loss because he knew that he could take,
yeah,
take everybody to task the next day.
Well, you know, he reads his team really well.
Yeah.
Great experience. When he has a cupcake, he rides them hard. When he has a tough SEC game on the road, he congratulates them for competing. Now they got to finish it. You got to punt the ball here. You can't just throw it up in the air. You'll give Florida the ball with a chance for a field goal, so you have to punt it.
That would mean James Burnett has done an excellent job today.
The only nightmare for an athlete. You know, the game I keep thinking about, remember that game that was over between Michigan and Michigan State?
Yeah.
All you got to do is punt the ball and
yeah,
it's over.
And the snap
yeah,
went over. Yeah,
it was bobbled and it went the other way. That's the only, seemed like a chance. Or a block.
Florida's got everybody up except one guy back. The return man back at the 15. They're coming. Kick, got it away easily. Fair catch taken at the 24 with 4 seconds. One play left for Florida.
Now, right here, Alabama cannot get a penalty. Florida has to, I think, have one of those plays with the laterals now. I don't see any other way. You can't throw it far enough
no. To
get it into the end zone.
It's going to have to be a hook and ladder type of thing. Or...
yeah, I don't think they have enough time to even line up for a field goal either. If it, that's what Nick just said. Look for hook and ladder right there.
And he said you got to wrap up. He's talking to Will Anderson, who's wrapped up just about everything today.
Yeah.
Here's the last play, barring a penalty. Emory Jones, all his receivers, I should say three of his receivers to his right, one to the left. Final chance for Florida. They bring a late fourth man on the rush. Jones is in trouble, dancing around, and down he goes, and that is ball game. And I think I said this in Atlanta in December. Alabama survives the Gators, 31-29.
And Florida says we can compete with anyone.
That's right. And Alabama now with their young quarterback knows that they can win on a hostile situation on the road. And this time they brought a delayed fourth guy. And that's when the pocket started to collapse and Emory Jones had to improvise.
missed extra point. Changed the whole dynamic of strategy in the game.
Winning coach is with Jamie Erdahl.
Coach, this game delivered as it was billed. I know consistency is a word that you were big on today, but was resiliency the answer in the end?
Well, I think so, and I think the offense did a great job of answering the bell in the game. You know, we didn't stop them on defense. We had some long yardage situations. We didn't execute very well. But the offense always answered the bell, and I think that was the key to the game. So, but our team needs to learn how to just maintain intensity throughout the game. I thought we got tired on defense. They looked a lot quicker than us. But, you know, we got a lot of good players. We just got to get them to play a little better.
And you could talk Bryce Young's ear off until it was blue about what it was going to be like here, but he had clock issues down the stretch, and he was the true field general. What do you have to say about his performance?
Well, he did a good job, but I also about had a heart attack a couple times when the shot clock's down to one. All right, and we're, you know, but he did do a great job. He managed the game well. You know, one of the things that was an issue for us is we like to go on clap, and the center couldn't hear the clap, so we had to go on silent. And when we went on silent, you know, we got a couple penalties because we weren't on the, all on the same page. It's what happened on the one-yard line with all the noise. So, but for the most part, guys did a pretty good job.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
So he's a pretty happy guy. See, that's
yeah,
what he said.
That's what I thought. And I'd walk in with that guy. I'd walk in anywhere with Will Anderson.
So would I. I go any place. I don't even care if it's enemy territory. And this is for Alabama, but they came out on top by two. And Bryce Young talking to Jamie down there after three touchdown performance. Now it's time for the play of the game presented by Jersey Mike Subs. There's a lot of candidates for this, but this was a two-point play at the three-yard line. And the Alabama defense does their job barely. And this is how Eli Gold, our good buddy, called it on the Alabama Radio Network.
Two-point conversion try. The running back, and he'll get to the one, and he is stopped. He is stopped. Alabama holds on the two-point conversion. Justin Aboigbe and Will Anderson stop the Gators on a two-point conversion at the two-yard line.
So, Florida plays very well, but they come up short. The 11th-ranked team in the country might not even lose that number 11 ranking, even though they lost
right
again. That's going to wrap it up for us. 31-29, top-ranked Alabama survives the Swamp. For Gary Danielson, Jamie Erdahl, our entire CBS crew, Brad Nessler saying so long from Gainesville. Final score, 31-29, top-ranked Alabama goes to 3-0. Florida drops to 2-1. We'll be back with Adam Zucker and company for the College Football Postgame Show, presented by Rocket Mortgage, right after these messages. So long from Gainesville.